So far in my Minecraft hardcore world, I survived 1,000 days. And I thought before we carry on, why not look back on this adventure and see how the world has progressed so far. So whether you're leaving this video on in the background, studying, or just trying to get to sleep, here is the full movie of my first 1,000 days so far in Minecraft hardcore. Enjoy. November 2020, I uploaded my first Minecraft Hardcore episode onto my channel, and I had no idea where it would take me. But unfortunately, on my recent Minecraft Hardcore world, it came to an end. And that's why I am beginning Minecraft Hardcore Season 3. Right here is where it all starts, and I have three main objectives for this first episode. One, just to make a cool base, as of course I need somewhere to sleep. Two, head to the Nether, and three, get full diamond armor. Hopefully you enjoy this video, and here is to a great Minecraft series. Oh, okay. I'd say this is a good looking seed. I'm just glad we haven't spawned on a little island. That would not be great. I was just going to say that this looks like village territory around here, and clearly it is. Now I've just got to really, really hope that there's going to be a blacksmith. Are we going to get lucky? I don't think so. Although I'm still going to grab the cords, because that's a great thing to get at the start due to the fact that we can steal all of the hay. Wait. What have I just seen? That's got to be the weirdest place I've ever seen emeralds ever. Oh, wait, I think there is actually a chest in here. Please have some food. Oh, apples. Okay, perfect. Those would be perfect for golden apples, although I don't have any gold. No, we need to save the villager. You're welcome. Oh, it's a baby. You need to stop. Oh, I hate this snow. You know what? I'll just leave him to it. Oh, the village continues, and there's some more hay.
Nice.
Look at those mountains. That's insane. But I am going to go and explore this area over here in the hopes that we can actually find another village, preferably a village with a blacksmith, because if I can find a blacksmith, there's a chance I could get armor, diamonds, food. Oh, there's no way there's another village. Okay, could this one have a blacksmith? I do not believe it does. Wait, maybe up here? My hopes and dreams have been crushed. Well, it's not that bad, because you know what? We can still grab the hay. There's so much of it.
I love it.
No. How dare you kill a villager? Oh, now you're going to kill me. I think I need to get used to the fact that I'm literally useless right now. But not for long, after we've got the hay. Wait, surely if I can manage to get to a full stack of hay, I should be able to get like 3 stacks of bread. If my maths is correct there. Oh, anything in here? Oh, wait, why so many apples? Okay, I actually feel like I was very spoiled there. I am going to grab a bed because I don't want to get killed by a creeper. Like I have a few times, I'm not going to lie. But ladies and gentlemen, the quest for a blacksmith continues. Oh, I think I'm going to go have to see what's over this mountain. So far, this seems like a very good seed. The only thing that's missing is a desert. Although I've got a feeling that I'm going to be doing a lot of walking today. Although, I say today, it is almost nighttime. Gonna have to find a nice little safe space, I guess. Oh, this is a cozy looking village. I think I'm actually going to sleep here for the night because it is getting quite dark. Hello, can I just steal this bed? Thank you very much. And it's officially day number one. Oh, I really like this village. I like these villagers, although I don't like them enough to not steal their hay. So, yeah, sorry, villagers. There's going to be so much to break. By the way, in my last episode 1, we completely confused everyone in the comments by all commenting epic. I feel like we need to choose another word to comment, and I mean, it's probably pretty obvious. Just comment the word hey, H-A-Y. Hopefully we can just completely confuse people in the comments. Is there any more that I can... Whoa, that cat is zooming. Is there any more hay that I can steal... borrow from this village. Wait, can I steal this bell? No, that's going to take way too long and probably not even give me it. A chest. I wonder if I can grab it from here. Yeah, call me a speedrunner. At least I got a nice little bit of armor now. Is that another portal? Oh, it is. Okay, we have to go visit that. It's just so far away. You know what? I can make the trek. Ow, 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 ow. Why am I always getting boots? Okay, that will definitely help though. Feather falling. I've just got to be careful these guys don't break because, I mean, they're gold. We all know what gold armor's like in Minecraft. Anyway though, villages and really, really cool landscapes aside, I believe it is time to start getting ourselves some tools. Getting ourselves geared up for this Minecraft hardcore adventure, let's say. In fact, I'm probably going to start off by making myself a nice little wooden pickaxe, meaning that I can grab myself some stone just like so. Now I can obviously make a stone pickaxe. You guys are Minecraft pros, you know. And now we must go on the quest for some iron. So I think I'm just going to go around and try and look for a small cave, I suppose, because I don't want to go into a really deep cave without having full iron tools and full iron armor. Wait, is this a cave? It's most definitely is not, although there could be iron down there. Oh, iron. Okay, I don't know if I'm going to be able to break this, though, because I don't have respiration. Yeah, this is definitely not going to work. Okay, I need to think of a plan. Okay, if I use some of these birch planks and then break these two, then I can stand on this block. There we go. Oh. We've done it. Minecraft 200 IQ. Oh, and there's some more. Okay, now I'm going to get some air. Grab the last couple of little bits. Oh, and grab some coal. And 7 more cobblestone. I can now make a furnace to cook the iron. And there we go. Would you look at that? I think it is time to go on an iron hunting mission. And so I think for all of the tools and all of the armor we need, about 30 iron. So let the hunting begin. I think we found a cave. Target acquired, ladies and gentlemen. In fact, I'm going to make some torches. It's very dark in here. All right, that's better. Oh, and here we go. The torches gave us luck. Okay, so I'm already on 10 iron. That's pretty good. We'll take a little bit of coal as well. Oh, it's you. Go on, explode. There you go. Get it out of your system. Oh, some more iron. We shall take that, even if it's a 2-vein. Come on, Mojang. All I want is just a nice big cave full of iron, and I'd be very appreciative. Oh, okay. This could be iron territory if I get lucky. Currently on 12. Oh, I think I found a spawner. Okay, well, obviously I found a spawner, and it's a zombie. Right, let's get this all lit up. Please be some good loot. Okay, I'll take a golden apple. Oh, an enchanted golden apple. Oh my. Okay, I'll definitely take that. It takes so long to find those, and I've actually just found one in the first episode. I'm so hyped. Definitely my best first episode. Wow, just look at it glisten. Matches my boots. Can we get some iron around here? Seeing a lot of copper and coal. Now on a total of 16. And some more. Just 3 more iron to collect. We have found it. Okay, if this is more than 3, that would be amazing. Oh, no. We literally need 1 more.
Hello there.
Oh, no, no, no. See, this is why I need iron. But we have found the last few pieces. We have got more than 30. I can finally make some armor because these mobs are scaring me so much. So if I could just... Oh, some more. Wait, I've literally found a jackpot. And I believe it is time to get out of here. Can't leave the iron behind, though. How have I gone from struggling to find any little bits of iron possible to having a stack of iron? This really is a good start. In fact, I'm also going to grab some coal before we leave. Now that should be enough to smelt the iron. And now I suppose we make a couple more furnaces. And now just fill them all up. I'm also going to make some bread while I'm waiting. Look at all of that. And now I suppose I just sit here and wait. Now I can make myself a chest plate, leggings, boots, and a helmet. Why not make some tools as well? Because I do not think my golden ones are going to last too long. So I'll make a sword, and then that should be about it. There we go. Mission complete. You can call me Iron Man from now on until I get diamond armor. Then you can call me Diamond Man or Zetro. It's up to you. I've definitely got to also make myself a shield. Ah, that's better. A lot more protected. Oh. Okay, this was such a hard thing to spot. I don't know how I spotted this. Oh, hello, zombie.
Hello.
This could be the second god apple. Okay, never mind. What about here? Oh, a name tag. Okay, I'll definitely take a name tag. I'll take the coal as well. And in fact, I can grab these quads because that could be an XP farm one day. And all this rubbish can just go in here. Moving on. Oh, this is a very cool looking cave. I don't think it's going to have much in it, but I'll have a little investigation. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm pretty sure I could literally die if I fall down there. Although I'm not going to lie, I'm still worried very much about the mobs, even though I'm looking snazzy in my iron armor. Oh, speaking of iron... Oh, no, there's a lot of mobs here. There's a lot of mobs. No! Oh, my heart. That creeper sound is always just so scary. It's always when you're in the middle of trying to do things as well. I was just trying to make some torches. Oh, glow squids, you seem a lot nicer. What have I just stumbled across? Okay, there's no way. Oh, and it goes even further. This is looking like diamond territory, although also mob territory. Okay, yeah, there's no way we're going over there. I'm literally still in episode 1. What am I doing? Oh, anything good? Okay, I'll take another golden apple. Still want to try and find some diamonds. Oh, I'll take the gold. Come on, Mojang, just give me some diamonds. That's all I need. All I need is 1 or 2 diamonds, and then I can leave this cave, finally.
Pizza time.
Oh, no. Yeah, I've got to get out of here. Whoa, 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 whoa. No, thank you. Diamonds. Yes. Okay, we just need to make sure these guys are gone first, and then I can grab them. Do you want to... explode there? Yeah, there you go. Finally, we're gonna leave with some diamonds. Okay, I'm hoping this isn't gonna be a big drop. Okay, nice. I can grab this one. Grab this one. There we go. We got the advancement. Okay, I'm actually very surprised we were able to get some. Oh my goodness, look at my inventory. Okay, I think I'm gonna have to start setting up a base as soon as I get out of here. Oh no, please tell me we're at the surface. There we go, and it's nighttime. Well, I suppose it's a good thing I've got a bed. There we go. Okay. Oh, we're at the ocean. I literally didn't even realize. Oh, I bet that is a good cave. But of course, my inventory is looking very full. What I'm going to do is go and find the village, because as you may know, I always like to put my starter base next to a village, so it's really easy to get a villager's trading hall going. So I'm pretty sure I grabbed the coords for that village that I found earlier. Well, one of the villages that I found earlier. Oh, it turns out I have gone the complete opposite direction and found myself at a completely new village. I think you know what time it is. Say goodbye, hey. I'm sorry, farmer. I'm gonna need this one. Thank you, village. It was amazing looting you. Oh, there have been a few villagers in this area, but what have I just spotted, ladies and gentlemen? It is a blacksmith. It is in the village, and it is gonna get investigated right now. Look at it shine over there. Everyone cross your fingers for some diamonds. Did it work? It did not. I guess we'll take some horse armor. Actually, I do have a saddle as well. I could get myself a horse, although, as we all know, the hay comes first. I'll be back in a second.
A few inches later.
How was it, episode 1? And I've just collected like 4 stacks of hay bales to get bread. Anyway though, hay aside, look at this area. I think this actually could be the perfect area to set up a nice little starter base. We've got a decent little lake over there. We've got a village, and I'm pretty sure right behind me, that lake over there leads into the ocean. Right, I've got an idea. We're gonna go over here. I'm gonna sleep on it, and I'm gonna tell you my decision in the morning. Yeah, let's make a starter base. Right, so first thing we need to do is, of course, get the materials. The main material, of course, to match the area is going to be wood. And I don't quite know where the house is going to go yet. But first, I think we're just going to collect loads of wood from here. And then we can get on with getting all the other smaller materials. Wish me luck. Okay, I think we did pretty good. I've got all of that oak. I did actually get some birch, just in case you needed it. Some saplings, sticks, apples, and 2 eggs. Now, what I want to do is have my house pretty much where this water's going, which is going to be a bit confusing, but I'll just show you what I mean.
What are you talking about, man?
So, it's probably going to be about on this level right here, and it's pretty much going to be 3 6x6 squares on each side. So, of course, one here, and then one, of course, on the level above. I'm going to have to do a lot of terraforming. But we're gonna have one square here, and then of course this last one, the layer above that one, right here. Jeez, we're really getting straight into this, aren't we? So we've got those there, and then pretty much the same thing going this way. Also, I didn't even expect to get it making a house this fast. We're whizzing through this. This is gonna be such a cool world. So there we go. We've got our squares. So I think these parts here are going to be used for plants, probably wheat or carrots maybe. And then obviously, speaking of the house, I'm thinking it's going to be over here in this mountain kind of thing, but not actually fully in the mountain. Okay, yeah, I definitely think the logs around the outside looks a lot better than just plain planks. Although one thing that would probably make it that little bit better would be some fences. And now just before anything, I think after I've put these pillars here and then over here as well, it should be time to add a roof. But remember, this is just the starter base. We're only going to be using this for now. So I guess it doesn't have to be anything crazy. So now I suppose I'm going to go ahead and make some stairs. I don't quite know how many we need, but that should be a couple of stacks. I've just realized that's definitely not going to be enough. Either way though, I'll just do the outline. I might actually have to get rid of some of this mountain. Yeah, I thought so. At least it'll look like it's built into the mountain, I suppose. And now that is the roof. Connected. Now just a few more layers, a bit of terraforming, and I got myself a roof.
Tomorrow.
Okay, I definitely say that is looking pretty decent to me, but there's one thing missing that I know we're all thinking about. Oh, that's better. Oh yeah, I'll also pop on the image on the screen now of the inspiration I got for this house. I'm not staring at the image looking at it, but I do definitely like that design. What do you think of the house so far? I think it's actually looking okay, for a starter base especially. But now, after doing a bunch of this build, I'm now realizing that I completely forgot to grab a bunch of other materials. You know, I'm needing torches, lanterns, stone, and I completely forgot to get all of that. So, I suppose I better go on a mission. Okay, I managed to get those extra materials, which hopefully should be enough. But you may have noticed I've got a bunch of wheat seeds in my inventory. I've got a hoe in my hand. And that is because I actually changed my mind about where we're going to put the crops. And I'll show you now. So I think I'm actually going to be putting the wheat seeds here and then just leaving these as kind of paths to get into the house, which is literally the opposite way around to what it was going to be. But I just think it will look a lot cooler. As you can see, I've tried to make it look all nice and even. Oh, it's going to look so cool when it's fully grown. It should be a pretty good source of food for the start, but I mean, with how much hay we've got, I don't think we're going to need food for a while. Either way, though, at least I've still got a nice little farm outside the house for now. Look how cool that looks. Why does this guy keep coming over to my bed? Look, look, watch this. I guarantee he's going to come over and sleep right here. See, look at this guy. He skips this bed and goes straight to this one. Why? You're lucky I've got another. Anyway, that is the base layer of the house pretty much done. There's actually only just decoration to add. It's a pretty simple house. So I'm going to quickly do that, and I'm hoping we can then move in. So, what do you think of the new house? I think it's looking kind of cool, but a little bit plain. I don't really know what to put here to make it more, I guess, decorative. And I was thinking about putting here, like, a bunch of glass, but I think it's cool to just have it, like, nice and open, you know? We can spy on the villagers. But now, I suppose I actually need to, you know, move in. Also, you might have seen that I dug around this area under here, which I think looks pretty cool. I don't know what I'm gonna put here. Maybe use it as, like, a storage area or something. But anyway, I need to move in. So, crafting table, chest, field. The chest up, another double chest, fill that up, and bed. Oh yeah, cannot forget the furnaces. There we go, home sweet home. I really do need some more stuff to put around it. I just don't have anything yet. Also, you might have already been able to tell, but this is kind of an upgraded version of the house in the last series. In fact, we're missing one thing. So I got a little bit of extra iron, and what I'm actually gonna do is make some buckets. There we go, now I can make two. Gotta grab some water from over here, and I should be able to make an infinite water source. There we go. And now I think just right here, I'm going to dig out a little pond. Nothing crazy, just a nice little small bit of water. Go on, everyone. Make fun of how I say it in the comments. Water.
I love what I'm being serious. I'm being serious.
In fact, we need to keep this layer full and then break it after we've placed the water. And then this can get filled back up. And actually, look over there. I am going to steal some of this. And now we have a nice little sugarcane farm. Nothing crazy, but I mean, I don't even need sugarcane yet. We just have a nice little patch growing there. That's cool. And in fact, I think that kind of now pretty much completes the house. Let me know what you think of it in the comments. I think it's a good little starter base. Wait, I've just realized one thing. If I go and just grab some more sugarcane... Now, all I have to do is make a nice little sugarcane farm here that will get me a bunch of paper, and then grab these leftover fences to make a nice little cow pen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what I'm thinking is if I can get some cows, that leather mixed with that paper, I should be able to get some bookshelves and make a full level enchanting table later on. So you, come with me. That would be great. Oh, hello. Come with me, sir. Oh, and you as well. Come on, let's get moving. You're not a cow. What are you doing here? There we go. That was easy enough. If you want to follow me, sir, greatly appreciate. Thank you very much. And now, if you guys want to just, Whoa. Can't be sharing that on YouTube. But now if I just do a bunch of cow breeding, we should get quite a bit. Oh, but in the meantime, some more flowers to decorate the area. Ah, that looks lovely.
One eternity later.
Okay, I've been AFK just constantly giving these guys wheat and then going in this cubby hole. And I reckon this is enough cows. And I also reckon that we've got enough sugarcane grown over here. So let's just take a look. Oh my goodness. I'd definitely say this is enough. I think we've got so much that I can probably just chop off this layer here and then leave all of this to, of course, grow. I'm sorry, but I think we all know what happens now.
No! God, please, no! No! No!
And now we'll just leave you two to, you know, eventually breed. But now I'm just going to head back to my house up here real quick. And let's just see how many books I can make. So I'm going to craft up a bunch of paper. And that, of course, makes us a bunch of books. Meaning if I grab this wood, we can make some bookshelves. And this up here looks like a nice little area for the enchanting table. If I just flatten it out a bit. And let's just say the enchanting table is going to go here. I suppose we'll put three here. Three this side. One here. And we're going to need a lot more. And there we go. I think that should be enough bookshelves to get a full level 30 enchanting table. Although there's something missing. I don't have an enchanting table. So I believe it is time to make some more pickaxes. And it is time to go mining for some diamonds. Just got to get to Y level minus 58, I believe. Goodness me, this is going to take a while. Also, if everyone's seeing this right now, could just comment like hashtag I don't like deep slate or hashtag no deep slate or just something signifying that you don't like deep slate. So then I know you're just like me. Okay, I feel like we're getting extremely... Yep, okay, we're going to go a different direction. I am not trying to deal with all that lava right now. I'm just looking for some diamonds. Oh, my goodness me. Oh, okay, okay, we'll block that up. We'll just continue this direction. Oh, we've hit a massive iron ore vein. I will grab those quads for later on, but that is going to be very useful. There's no way. Oh, my goodness. Okay, maybe it was a good thing that all of that lava is there because it made me go this direction. Please be an 8 vein. You don't have to be, but I just really appreciate it. Okay, it's not going to be an 8 vein, but it still could be like a 6 vein or something. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh my goodness. Okay, it actually is an 8 vein. No way. You have no idea how excited that makes me. That literally took like 5 minutes. This is the best start. I'm not joking. So out with the old, in with the new. I'm going to have to make myself... Okay, what is that crafting recipe? Sorry, I'm going to have to make myself a diamond pickaxe like that. And now I'm actually going to need to get some obsidian for this enchanting table. Maybe if I find a lava source, I can use this bucket of water and do it that way. There's probably a much quicker way to do this, but I'm done. That right there, my friends, is a ruined portal. Right, surely there's got to be some lava here. Oh, wait, I'm so dumb. There's literally loads of obsidian here. What am I talking about? I don't even have to put the water onto the lava. I can literally just take it. I can't. Oh, my God, I'm so dumb. Feel free to flame me in the comments. Wait, so my house is right over there, and there's literally not one, but two lava pits right here, and I traveled all those blocks. I can't believe that, but I mean, I guess at least I'm home, and I've got the obsidian ready to go. So we need to put that there, and that there. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment of truth. Hey, there we go. I am now going to be able to fully enchant to level 30. Now, of course, I need to get to level 30, and I think probably the easiest way to do that is just mine a bunch of quartz, meaning I'm going to be exploring the nether, which I'm not going to lie, I'm kind of nervous about. We could easily die in there, but you know what? We'll stick it through. We'll be able to do this. I hope. It's time to go into the nether first time. Wish me luck. I'm genuinely worried. Please don't be a bad spawn. Please don't be a bad spawn. And I'm in a tree. Okay. Oh, and there's a ghast. Oh, wait, I can get the advancement here. Yes. There we go. Return to sender. Oh, a big lump of quartz. Do not mind if I do. Oh, I've spotted a bastion. Can't say I'm going to be looting it right now, but it's cool to know it's there. I'm going to grab these quartz, though. And there we go. Level 30. Amazing. So that goes there. That goes there. Please give me, like, fortune, efficiency, or something like that. And it's just unbreaking. Yeah. Great. Well, I suppose there's one good thing. I have a blacksmith right here, which means I can use this grindstone to disenchant the pickaxe. And now I've got to go get a bunch more XP. Wish me luck.
3 weeks later.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen. 19th time is the charm. Yes! Finally! Okay, I'm breaking 3, efficiency 4, and fortune 3. I knew it would be worth enchanting more than once. Oh my goodness. Okay, that's pretty much, not quite, but almost a god pickaxe. Now, of course, I've got this god pickaxe. What better to do with it than go for a nice little mining trip to get ourselves some full diamond armor, because that's pretty much what we need now. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, it's happened. Okay, please. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's definitely not going to be an 8 vein. Please don't just be a 1 vein, though. Okay, I believe it's a 4 vein. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it looks like it is just a 4 vein, and we managed to get a total of 13 diamonds. So I believe that means we're on 17 diamonds total. So I need around 8 more. That should be doable. I've just got a mine for a very, 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 very long time. Time to go speed mode. Ladies and gentlemen, I think it is time. This could be the final diamond vein we get before getting full diamond armor. This looks like a 2 vein. Okay, we're going to take it anyway. Now on 19 diamonds. That means I literally need 1 diamond. You did this, diamond shovel. If I didn't make you, I'd have full diamond armor right now.
A few moments later.
Ladies and gentlemen, diamonds. Just as I wasn't expecting it, just sat here mining away. We have struck diamonds, ladies and gentlemen. That is a 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 vein. Oh my goodness. Mission success. Time to go home and reap the rewards. It is time, ladies and gentlemen. Diamond leggings, diamond helmet, diamond boots, and the best armor of all, a diamond chest plate. Look at that. Oh yeah, and you know what? We'll make ourselves a diamond sword and a diamond axe. You know what? I'm feeling rich, okay? And we'll make a diamond hoe. Why not? Now, ladies and gentlemen, we've been to the nether. We've got a nice, lovely looking house over here. A nice little cow farm, a nice sugarcane farm around there. We have a full level enchanting table up there, which I did not expect to get today. And something I didn't expect even more to get is full diamond armor and almost a god pickaxe. But ladies and gentlemen, I believe I'm going to have to end the video there because I have a bunch of plans that I want to do. And I mean, I can't get doing them if I'm still recording episode one. So I'm going to get recording episode two literally now because I have a whole list of fun things to do. So I hope you enjoyed episode one. Make sure to comment for things you want me to do. And I suppose I'll see you on this new adventure in Minecraft Hardcore Season 3, Episode 2. Thank you for watching. In this video, I built myself a brand new gunpowder farm so I'd be able to get myself infinite TNT to get infinite netherite from the nether. And it doesn't stop there. Ladies and gentlemen, in just episode 2, I managed to get full netherite armor and actually enchant it a bunch just to make sure I wouldn't die in this world. We even got a nice little villager farm going, so hopefully you enjoy this video. It is an insane one for just episode 2, but trust me, episode 3 is even crazier. Anyway, enjoy the video. Now, of course, the first thing I need to do is grab every single material for the creeper farm, and I'll put time lapses on the screen right now. I managed to get a bunch of cobble. I also smelted some cobble to get smooth stone slabs, and then chopped down loads and loads of trees to get these oak trap doors. And as you can see, there's a lot. But there's also a bunch of materials that I still need to grab. The main one being glass. And I don't think I have a desert round here whatsoever. So in fact, it might actually be a good idea to go over to the coast. Swim, 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 swim. And now very soon after we've got all these materials, we should be able to build a pretty good creeper farm, which is going to give me loads of TNT to explode in the nether. Because if you don't know, I really do like to explode TNT in the nether. Hey, yo, Mr. Sheep. Why are you hanging out over here, man? Don't want to drop down there, do you? I'm sorry for your loss. All right, this is not exactly loads of islands of sand, but I mean, it's a start. I actually only need about 8 stacks, so we might actually be able to get all I need right here. It feels so weird. Of course, I'm so used to being able to be like... But that's not the case now. There is the third stack, I believe. That is the fourth stack. Okay, if I now go a bit deeper, I'm going to do it, but I've got a feeling that water is going to start to come through. Yep, I was right. I'm drowning.
I'm under the water. Please help me.
I guess I'll try and stick to the sand over here. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Right, I'm going to move over here. Oh, and there's mobs. Goodbye. Ooh, look at this little gold mine here. Okay, I'm hoping my shovel isn't going to break before I actually get to the 8 stacks, but there's a possibility it will. And... there we go. 8 stacks. Finally. I'm now going to head back over to the base. Hopefully not try and get killed by one of these guys. I think I'm actually going to make some golden apples when I get home, if I can, to get me out of those sticky situations. Okay, yeah, I can make a bunch of ingots. And now I have a bunch of golden apples to spam when I get in dangerous situations. Now I just need to grab some wood for the chests. Of course, it's going to collect all of the gunpowder from the creepers. And we actually need 18 chests, so I'm going to make those now. I also need 26 redstone comparators, meaning I need 78 redstone. I definitely didn't use a calculator for that. Oh, here we are. Fantastic. I'll take that. And I've got fortune, so hopefully we only need to get a couple of veins. In fact, just this one more vein should actually get us to the whole 78 that we need. Oh, wait. I just realized I completely forgot to unpause my recording. But, I mean, I made the 26 repeaters anyway, with some leftover stone and, of course, the redstone we just grabbed. So those can go in there. And now, for some reason, I need 64 torches. I guess it's time to head back down to the mine. Oh, here we are. Don't mind if I do. So now, if we make this wood into sticks, I can make those. Buckets, of course, they're pretty self-explanatory. A lever, I can make that too. And then I think I need 3 bits of redstone. I'd think I'd need more, but apparently that's all I need. And it's saying I need dirt. I'm guessing that's for building blocks. And then pretty much all the other materials I needed for the creeper farm were a bit random, like observers, hoppers, quite annoying things to make. But after doing a bunch of mining, etc., I managed to get every material I needed to get building the creeper farm. Now, I'm going to make a lectern for one reason and one reason only. Now, look at my tools. They're suffering. Look at them. They're literally crying. The almost god pickaxe is literally on red health. We need to get ourselves a mending villager. Okay, maybe if I go break this guy's thing. Is he going to go normal? Yes, he does. Okay, that's amazing. So now, if you could just give me mending. No, that's the wrong profession, sir. Right, now we're going to break this. Come on, just become a librarian. That's all you have to do, man. Oh, he's done it. Has he got mending? It's going to be insane if I get it first time.
Got it!
Okay, imagine. Come on, man, you want to have another go? Yes, there we go. Okay, yeah, that's not right. Okay, he actually keeps taking the profession fairly quickly, which is good, so it shouldn't take too long to actually get mending. Oh, I saw the M and I thought that was it.
You're teasing me, you naughty naughty.
Mate, there's no way. Come on, just become a librarian. Yes, finally. Oh, wait, okay. I need to quickly find the materials to actually get the trade, or else this guy is just going to lose it, and that is all going to just be a big waste of time. Okay, I have a plan. I can use these planks and these two flint to make a fletching table. Now, I'm going to make as many sticks as possible. Now, I just need to find a villager. Oh, okay, this guy. So, if I break this, can you please, please just give me a stick trade? Okay, there we go. Now, I can grab some emeralds, and there we go. I have got the mending book, finally. Okay, now, I'm going to block you in because, mate, I do not want you to lose this trade. Please just stay right here. Right, we're going to chuck up some cauldrons here, and please, man, just stay put and don't die. Well, at least that should be enough sticks now. Hey, give me all your emeralds. Very nice. And now you can give me your mending books. Thank you very much. Great doing business with you. Now, it's all good having these mending books, but I mean, they're kind of useless if I can't do anything with them. So, of course, once again, I'm going to head back down to the mine, and I'm going to break every single piece of iron I see, and hopefully I'm going to end up with just enough to make myself an anvil. And there we go, an easy bit of iron. I think I'm going to return home, though. We've got about a stack and 15. We'll take it. Oh, finally out. Now I can smelt all of this iron. And I think for now, while I'm waiting for that iron to smelt, I'm just going to chuck a couple of enchantments on my tools, even if they're not the best for now. It's still better than having nothing. In fact, that is a very good enchantment. So I'm going to put you there. We'll put mending on the pickaxe, mending on the sword, mending on the shovel. Honestly, that feels so much better. We now have mending on all the tools, and we've got a new little friend over there now. So now I was finally ready to build a creeper farm, but that was when I realized that this creeper farm had to be in an ocean, and I didn't actually have an ocean anywhere near me. So I decided to go with the creeper farm I've built before in my world, meaning I just had to get a couple of extra items, but luckily most of them were similar to the other farm. Right, so I'm at the spot where I'm going to build this creeper farm, and I'll put a link in the description for this farm, just in case you, of course, want to build it yourself. And now I'm just going to run through the base part pretty fast, because, I mean, I'm pretty sure I've done this quite a few times now, and I really hope this lines up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. And then all of this inside part here, other than this outer layer block, has to get removed. Now I must make myself a lovely little infinite water source. These things are so handy because now I can just fill my inventory up with water. And then if I've done this right and it's all symmetrical, this water should all go into the middle perfectly. Okay, this is looking good so far, but this is the decider. Will this go to the middle symmetrically? Is that even a word? It's looking good. And there we go. Perfect. But I guess it's not quite finished yet. I'm going to dig out this middle bit now. Okay, why does that actually look so satisfying? The water just stopping right where it needs to. Oh, that looks so cool. Wow. And I need to dig out a 3x3 area 3 blocks down. So we need to go one deeper. And then I've also got to dig out 2 blocks wider from each side. This shovel is literally about to break. I called it. So I'm going to grab all this stuff here, which I think is needed. So we go rail, chest, hoppers, chest, more rails, torches to activate the rails. And that right there is the item collection system done. And then this star shape here is pretty much going to get filled in with magma blocks. And I think that is actually to kill all the creepers and spiders that fall down. These fence gates are going to go in the middle, but now we can let all the water flow down. Look at that. Nice and symmetrical. I can't believe I did that first time. Now, if anyone's building this farm along with me, I want you to watch carefully. What we're going to do is go to the middle and go up 1, 2, 3. Place your building block, go out 4 blocks on each side, and then place another row next to it. Put a block here in the middle. Chuck down all of the repeaters with a little bit of redstone on the edges. Torch. Put all these ticks all the way to the end, which is 3 clicks for each one, if you didn't know. I'm going to place a dispenser and then build out 8 blocks on each side. And then with all the cobblestone in my inventory, I'm going to turn this into a diamond kind of shape. There's half the layer done, and there's the other half done. So there's one layer finished. Now all I do is go block, observer, dispenser, and then do this diamond shape kind of layer again on the same level as the observer. So I'm just going to keep doing that, and then we'll be able to get on to doing the creeper farm roof, and I'll be pretty much done. There we go. We are now one step closer to having this creeper farm fully done and being able to get TNT and get full netherite armor. But I'm now remembering I forgot one thing. As you can see, I've got lots of oak trap doors, and I've got them for one reason and one reason only. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to place them on these blocks right here to make sure that we only get creepers and, of course, spiders spawning. And from when I've built this farm in the past, I can safely say that this is the worst part of building this farm. It takes so long. I also think think, ladies and gentlemen, it is finally time for me to get a netherite beacon in Minecraft Hardcore. Well, not this episode, it's literally episode 2. But I think this is finally the series when that is going to happen. If you are hyped about that, let me know, because I don't know. I think it will be possible. It's just going to take a lot of dedication and going AFK and breaking sand. But I'm going to get it done eventually. So now you're seeing what the roof is looking like beforehand. And this is what the roof looks like after. Now, all I need to do is fill up each one of these dispensers. What I also think would be a good idea is to place water on all of these blocks around here. It's going to take a long time. Well, for me, not for you. But it will mean if I fall from that AFK spot when I do make it, it's going to be a lot safer. There we go. Now, I feel like this is just going to be a lot safer, like, because I'm going to be AFK up there. In case I fall, then I'll land in water and it won't actually kill me. Unlike when I've been dropping down here and when I've missed the water, it actually almost killed me earlier. It got me to like 2.5 hearts. But anyway, aside from that, though, we're all good. Now, I need to find a redstone torch and I don't actually know where I put it. It's fine. I'll just craft a new one. Look at that. We've already got our first farm and it's only episode 2. And it is about to be a working farm. Pretty much what I'm going to need to do is go over here into the middle. And I have to activate this by putting on the torch, then breaking it. There we go. Which will now mean the water on each of these levels is going to go in and out. There we go. Pushing creepers into the middle. Perfect. Now, all that is left to do is put this minecart here and activate it so it can collect all the materials and put them in here. And now I need to find my Y coordinate, which is 63. Add 123 to that, which is level 186, and go all the way up to that level. And now the final block is going to be the platform block. Now, I'm just going to obviously build around here, which is going to be the AFK spot. In fact, I'm going to make it just a little bit wider, just to be safe. So I can put the doors here, and I'm going to put a water bucket here, just to make it easier to get down. And now it is safe to say we have a fully working creeper farm. But now I'm going to go AFK in this thing to see how much gunpowder I can really get, because we're going to need thousands, because I'm going to be getting loads of TNT.
1 hour later.
And ladies and gentlemen, after exactly 1 hour of being AFK, I got 10 stacks of gunpowder. That's not terrible. But if I want a lot of netherite, I'm gonna need a lot more.
3 hours later.
There we go. That's a lot better. Now, just the final step before we have loads and loads of TNT, getting loads of sand. And before I find a desert, I want to see how much I can just get from little river areas like round here. I'm hoping a decent amount, although I am literally just using an unenchanted diamond shovel that's probably gonna break very soon. You know what? I've got a better idea. And there we go. There are a bunch more quartz and golden nuggets to add to the collection. I think you can probably guess what I've done here. I've got some lapis. I've got 33 levels. I'm hoping I can get a pretty good enchantment for my shovel. Efficiency 3. Okay, not great. I'm gonna risk it. I'm gonna disenchant. Now I've disenchanted it. We're gonna go for one more go. Oh, okay. Definitely a lot better. I'm breaking 4. I'm breaking 3. What? Efficiency 4. That is gonna be so much quicker. These flat patches of sand here, I could actually just grab a bunch from here. This sand over here would actually be really easy to transport, seeing as my house is right over that way. Bunch of TNT, another great way to start the day. I'm gonna put it in here for now, but I believe we should be able to make a bit more out of this sand we've got here. There we go. It's looking good. It's looking good. Just gotta get a bit more sand. So... And there we go. For now, a nice little 7 stacks of TNT. Now, I'm going to take these 7 stacks of TNT over to the nether, and I'm going to see if this is just enough to get me, of course, full netherite armor, but also if I can get myself some tools as well. That would be amazing. Okay, this seems to be like a fairly low point down, so I'm going to start mining here, and we're just going to hope that there's not going to be loads of lava that ends up killing me. Okay, I'm at level 28 right now. Oh, I hate lava. And I need to get to roughly about level 15. I think that's pretty much the best level to mine at. Level 21, 20, 19, 18, level 16, and level 15. There we go. Now, what I'm going to do is pretty much just mine a straight line for as long as possible until I hit lava. In fact, I'm also going to grab these quartz to fix up my pickaxe, because of course now we've got mending, which is literally coming in so handy. Oh, look at that. He's feeling better already. And I think I'm going to place the TNT one block apart so we can get maximum efficiency. Normally, I have to do a lot of twists and turns, but I'm hoping that we can just do one long straight line of literally 7. Oh, okay. Yeah, I spoke too soon. Oh, there's so much lava literally everywhere. I literally spoke too soon. Okay, I think I've found a path that isn't going to be filled with lava. Oh my goodness, I keep speaking too soon. Maybe I can block it off. Okay, there we go. This is why I need netherite armor. Oh, finally. Oh, basalt. Why? I'm just getting issue after issue. But you know what? We'll troop through and we'll get this TNT placed. Oh, hello there. I will take that. In fact, I need to probably empty out my inventory to get it. There we go. Oh, wait, and it's a 3 vein as well. Okay, I'll definitely take that. I believe I can now get placing all of the TNT. And I'm hoping that's actually going to work, but I suppose we'll see. So there's the first stack placed. By the way, if you think I can do anything better to get netherite, like to up my chances of getting it, let me know in the comments because I'd really appreciate it. Because in this season, of course, like I've said, we do want to get a full netherite beacon. Finally, it's been a goal for quite a while. It's time to actually finally complete the mission of getting that beacon because I've wanted one literally for over a year now. There's another stack complete. Only 4 more to go. This is going to be a massive explosion. This is actually my first time getting netherite, of course, in this new season. I mean, it's my first time doing a lot of things in this new season. It's literally episode 2. What am I talking about? Okay, I've now realized that the steps are right there and the TNT is here. So what I'm going to do is dig a different direction just to make sure we can actually place all of this TNT up. Oh, and we get some more ancient debris. Lovely jubbly. Can we get any more? Okay, you know what? I'll take one. We can now make, actually, technically, our first ingot. Oh my goodness. I just fell into the hole. I was placing that TNT. I didn't realize it exploded. Oh my goodness, that was so close. Okay, I suppose I'm going to quickly just explode this TNT. And now I'm going to run as fast as I can. Actually, I'm going to dig. I'm just going to dig away just to make sure I can get away. Oh no, and I'm literally getting cornered by lava. Is this guy trying to kill me? Oh my gosh, this is so scary. These guys are all trying to kill me right now. Get away. Go. Oh, and another hiding up there. Thank you very much. Don't mind if I do. Any more ancient debris around here? Oh, yes. Oh, okay. This could be a 3 vein or just a 2 vein, but you know what? I'll still take it. Any ancient debris is good ancient debris to me. And we have another little catch. It's just a 1 vein, but I'll take it all day, every day. This lava might be a bit of an issue. Please don't get... I was going to say please don't get set on fire. Ah! I'll be taking that. And you, I'll take you too. Thank you very, very much. Oh, you love to see it. You really do. Oh my goodness. I thought I just found a 4 vein. Still a very nice looking 3 vein though. By the way, if you want to comment how many you think I'm going to get by the end, that would be cool. But after all that, ladies and gentlemen, I think I'm at the end of this tunnel. But I've now realized that I've also still got just over a stack and a half of TNT left. So I guess I'll just quickly explode it over here. I honestly cannot begin to imagine how much TNT I've placed in the nether in my time. To be completely honest, like tens of thousands. And here's some more to add to the collection. Oh, I better run away. Fly, my TNT. Fly. Okay, here's at least one piece. In fact, I believe that is pretty much it. But on the way home, I'm going to move to the other side. And I'll let you know if I manage to find any more. I'm guessing not, but I mean, I'll hope for the best. And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. I have found the exit. I'm out. And now I can successfully say I have made it out the nether with all the ancient debris. And for the grand reveal, a total of 25 ancient debris, which I think is pretty decent and should be enough for now. Now, I was about to craft a smithing table, but I'm pretty sure, if I'm not mistaken, I should be able to get one from a villager house. There we go. Cook up this ancient debris quickly. Oh, we got the netherite scrap. And then while I was, of course, smelting that, I did actually make some ingots, which means I can make the netherite ingots. Look at them. There they are. Let's just take it all in for a second. Now I'm going to take off this armor. Oh, look at it. Look at it. It's amazing. I can't believe it. And there is the advancement. Cover me in debris. I'm joking. I know you say it like debris, but I'm just trying to be funny for the video, you know? Anyway, though, I'm going to slap all of this on. Oh my goodness. And in fact, I've got 2 more left, which is nice and convenient to turn the 2 best tools that I have into netherite. Okay, yeah, I am definitely fully geared up now. Oh yeah, and if you'd like to give me a name for my sword and my pickaxe, I'm going to choose a name from the comments to put onto a name tag and then onto the tools. So if you want to drop a name, yours might get chosen. And I'll be picking them, of course, in episode 3. But wait, did you really think that was going to be the end of the episode there? Ladies and gentlemen, in this Minecraft article world, I do not want to die. Which means this armor, it's not going to cut it. We need the best enchantments possible in Minecraft. So I'm going to get God armor, which starts off by putting mending on every single piece of armor I have. Now, this armor can never break. Now, I've got a villager here and a couple of villagers over here. So, the first step to getting this god armor is getting these villagers to get together so we can have more villagers to make trades. So, this wall should do it. And then, I'm pretty sure there's no way these villagers are going to be able to escape. They'll be all mine. I'm joking. I'll let them have a bit of fresh air once in a while. So, now I'm going to get this guy to go to the other guy. Go. Keep going. And stay in there. Now, to be honest, if you guys could just have some babies, that would be amazing. Oh, don't worry. I won't look. You guys just do your thing. Don't mind me. Now, I've also just stolen some villager beds because I've just realized that you also need to have the right amount of villager beds for them to breed. So, we're going to have one there, and one there. Oh, this guy's just snuck his way in here. All right. I guess we're going to need a bed for you as well. Now, I'm going to come back at a date and hopefully there's going to be some villagers and I'm going to be able to get some librarians going. Okay, it is the next day and the question is there a villager? I'm really hoping so. Yes, it's worked. Oh, that makes me so happy. But now, though, it is time for me to make some more beds and we're going to be churning out villagers left, right, and center. So I'm going to grab all the wool that I've got and we're going to be able to make 5 beds, which is definitely going to be enough for now. Look at that. We've got 2 villagers now. Perfect. But I'm going to be taking this guy and I'm going to try and turn him into a librarian. And first of all, I think we're probably going to go for protection.
Thousands of tears later.
Yes! Oh my goodness. Okay, finally. This has literally taken me like the past half an hour. Thank you so much. I'm taking this trade before he loses it. So I should be able to buy myself a... Wait. What? Why did his price go up so much? Can't believe that.
I can't believe you've done this.
You take these, and you take these, and you give me that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is now safe to say I have full prop 4 armor, and since I don't actually have an XP farm, I'm actually going to wait until the next episode to get all the finicky enchantments, like, you know, like Feather Falling, Aqua Infinity, all that kind of stuff. I'm just going to stick to the main enchantments, which are Mending, Protection 4, and of course, Unbreaking. Luckily, I've got quite a few lecterns left. I wouldn't be surprised if I got on breaking on the first trade. Aww. These are all the really good kind of enchantments that I'm going to be getting in the next episode when I actually have an XP farm. Because if I do it now, it's going to be impossible for me to get them onto the armor. Although I am thinking about making a bit of an Enderman farm in the next video. I don't know. I'm just saying, it could be a good idea.
Much, much, much later.
Oh my goodness, that is very expensive. But finally, okay, I'm going to need to get one of these trades quickly before he moves on to a different trade. And there we go. I can finally get full unbreaking on my armor now as well. I really hope I'm going to have enough levels. Maybe I should have done it in a different pattern. No way. It only costs like 6 levels. That is so much cheaper than I thought it was going to be. Ladies and gentlemen, I am now almighty in Minecraft Hardcore. I literally have Mending, Protection 4, and Unbreaking on all of my armor. And I think it's safe to say we won't be dying in Minecraft Hardcore anytime soon. Although, we are going to have to find a place for those villagers to live in the next episode. Hopefully you enjoy this episode and I'll see you in a bit. Goodbye. In my last hardcore world, I had the world's biggest potato farm. Now, in this world, I decided that I wanted to make the biggest carrot farm, which includes over 100,000 carrots, which would give me infinite carrots and eventually lead to infinite golden carrots when I make a gold farm in the very near future. And it was a very long and tedious task, but I got it done in the end, and the end result was amazing. Anyway, enjoy the video. Now, quickly, before I get to building this giant carrot farm, I know we're all thinking the same thing. Zetro, you don't even have full netherite tools. I know, it's disgraceful. So, as you can see in this chest, I've got a bunch of TNT that, of course, I got from this amazing... That is not meant to be there. This amazing gunpowder farm. I've got some flint and steel and I'm ready to head into the nether to get some more ancient debris because I have to have full netherite tools, let's be real. So I'm going to head all the way down here. Then I suppose just dig pretty much a different direction to last time. Oh, great. I've got a feeling I'm going to be spending a lot of time blocking off the lava. Oh, baby. And now I think I've probably dug enough, judging from the fact that I've had to empty my inventory full of netherrack for about 8 times. I think this is around 10 or 11 stacks of TNT. So we should get a decent bit of ancient debris. It is now time to explode the TNT, and it's exploding time. Whoa, it's beautiful. Oh, straight away getting a couple of bits. Oh, we've spotted some more. Oh, there it is. Oh, I've spotted one. Oh, another one vein. I'll still take it though. Another 3 vein. I actually think that ancient debris hunting trip went a lot better than the one in the last episode. I'm actually kind of excited to see how much I've got. Okay, so it looks like we got a total of 36 ancient debris. I'm also going to put that 36 netherite scrap with the 5 I already have, which means that we can make a total of 10 netherite ingots. I'm going to make you into netherite, and I'm going to make you into netherite. Oh, okay. I literally didn't even think I was going to get an advancement. Anyway, now that I've got the right tools for the job, I'm going to be using all of this deep slate, and I've got even more in a chest over there if I need it. I'm going to be using it to mark out the area where our giant carrot farm is going to go. And now I'm thinking this could be a perfect spot for the farm. It's just going to be a lot of work. So I suppose we'll start the first corner here, and then I guess later on we can calculate how many carrots I'm actually going to get. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we have made it across the water. And I've actually just realized I'm going to basically be encapsulating this whole lake. I'm pretty sure that's going to be wide enough. Now I need to do the length, which is going to be so long. This is where it gets interesting. I'm going to have to do a lot of terraforming if I want to actually be able to place all of the carrots I need to, which might be a bit of a task. Literally having to dig so much. Okay, I think this is as far as I'm going to go. I don't even know if I've got enough deep slate to make the outline. Now, I've added it up, and this way actually equals to around 185 blocks, and this side adds up to 276 blocks, which I believe means this is going to give me around 51,000 carrots. And that's not including fortune, which is probably going to take it way over 100k. That is insane. But I've managed to get some farming, so I'm going to grab these. In fact, this all can go in this chest here. And with my brand new shiny netherite hoe, look at it glisten. It's actually not glistening. It's quite the opposite. I'm going to go get these first carrots placed. So when I'm doing other things like terraforming and stuff, I've at least got these growing. And then the farm will grow and grow and grow until we finally have the biggest carrot farm in Minecraft Hardcore. In fact, I can just quickly take this out now. And now I can get placing all these carrots in hopefully quite a satisfying time lapse. Here's the question. Is all this dirt in my inventory right here going to be enough to fill this ocean? I'm guessing not, but I'm going to give it a go. After I keep running around here, I realize more and more that it's going to take so long to terraform. There's no way I've used already 2 stacks of dirt. Okay, yeah, I'm definitely going to have to collect more. Although it might be a good idea to do some terraforming after I've used up all the dirt I've already got. But first, I've got to use up all of this. Oh, no. I'm just realizing. Imagine all the sea life that's just going to be trapped under here. One like equals one rip. Comment hashtag save the fish. And some more dirt here. And now I have run out. So I guess terraforming is pretty much my only option. Let me just enchant my shovel quickly. I'm really hoping for efficiency 4. Oh, there we go. You can go on there, and you can go on there. And now with these enchantments, I'm hoping we shouldn't have any shovel issues when trying to do all the terraforming. Although there's one issue, and that is the fact that they are very, very broken. I think you know what time it is. Oh, jackpot. Oh, that's so much better. Now that I have the right tools for the job, I don't even have an excuse to not terraform anymore. I think this is actually the first time I've really needed dirt in quite a while. Oh my goodness, I forgot how deep this really goes. You're telling me I'm going to have to destroy this all the way going that way, and I've got to destroy all this over here, somehow get rid of this lava. I suppose I should probably get started. Well, it's definitely safe to say that I've got a lot more dirt for the terraforming now. Another thing I did in between the last episode and this one is also, as you can obviously see, do a bit of tree farming, which is coming in very handy right now as I need to make some chests. The reason I need to make all these chests is literally just because this terraforming is going to give me so many materials. Why are these carrots not growing? Is it because, like, I need to do the water thing so they can actually grow? I'm not even too sure. Please, while I'm terraforming, if you guys could just grow, that would be amazing. You know what? You guys can just sit along here and collect up all the dirt that I'm going to get from terraforming, because it is going to be a lot. Anyway, I probably should stop stalling and just start terraforming. I think I'm pretty much going to go from this side, going all the way to that side. And then I'm hoping I should have enough dirt to cover this whole lake. How in the world have these carrots still not grown? Is it actually because I haven't put this water down? Is that the reason? Come on, carrots. Do you really need water just to grow? Okay. Well, I mean, that does make sense. Is that better? Are you actually going to start growing now? I hope so.
A few moments later.
Okay, now we're starting to see a little bit of progress. Almost an inventory of carrots, I'd say, is pretty decent now, I suppose. I'm going to go place them down and eventually we'll get all the way to the end. There's one row done. There's another row. And another row of carrots. I actually don't know how I'm going to manage to finish this in like under a couple of weeks. Well, at least that's all those carrots placed. I think you and I both know what I have to do now. So now that I had all of the hills and stuff gone, the last thing pretty much to do before, of course, placing all the carrots was just to flatten out the whole area, which is exactly what I did, and it's safe to say that it took a very, very, very long time, but it was definitely worth it to have the biggest carrot farm in Minecraft Hardcore. There it is. There is the massive area that I'm going to turn fully into carrots. So I think I can probably go digging. In fact, you know what? I'm just going to break all of these bad boys. What am I doing? I need to use this. I guarantee I'm getting so much more now that I'm using Fortune. Look at that, like 5.5 stacks of carrots already. You see? There you go. There's already another full inventory. Oh, there's another full inventory done. I'm stacking these carrots up quick. And there's another. Now, I've gotten rid of all the carrots, and believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, that is 7,770 carrots. Now, I want to get placing all these carrots and pretty much making this whole farm, but I mean, as you can see, I have one issue. I have a single netherite hoe, so I need a lot more. So I guess I can just use these leftover diamonds I've got to make some hoes. I will take some of these, and now these can go onto these. Now we've definitely got enough hoes for this mission. In fact, if we're gonna do this, we're gonna do it properly. I'm not gonna randomly place the water. We are gonna do it symmetrical. So I think I'm gonna place water, count 10 blocks, and then place another bucket of water, and do that for all of this row, then maybe every like 5 or so rows going over that way. Oh, we get into the grassy area now. There we go. That is the first row done. Now I'm just gonna make sure it is all correct. Yep, it is correct. This has been such a satisfying episode. I am amazed. Look at this. And it's only episode 3. Now, I'm also going to quickly grab these carrots that I completely forgot about over at my house here. And now I've chucked those carrots in a chest quickly with those diamond hoes, because there's one more thing I want to do before I actually get to finishing that carrot farm. And that is go mend up this pickaxe. Of course, you know I've been going to the Nether a lot to fix up my tools. But I've actually got another method as well. And that is just holding my pickaxe while doing a bunch of trades. Why did I just make 64 oak buttons? Now I'm just going to empty out my inventory a little bit. Grab these wonderful carrots and, of course, the diamond hose. And now I think we all know what it's time to finally go and do, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to fulfill this video. Now, quickly, I've got to take out all the animals because we need room for the carrots. So, this stack of carrots is going to go in my offhand. And we're going to get placed. Carrot, I feel like this is going to get a bit boring. Wow, this is taking a lot longer than I expected. I'm pretty sure this took me around half a day. And at the time of recording, I've literally just posted a community tab post. As you can see, my wrist is suffering. Cookie God type beat. But yeah, you have no idea how badly I've wanted to use an auto clicker for this. I'm not going to lie. I think for now, though, I'll just carry on doing it manually as much as possible. But don't be surprised if I pull out the old auto clicker. Oh, help me. Okay, why does that seem a lot more than when I did that? I guess because that's longer, so I can't do as much. But this just looks like such a massive chunk that I've just done. Okay, I'm going to be real with you guys, all right? I did not think it was going to take this long. I've been doing this for a couple of days now, but still no auto clicker. Okay, maybe I used it for a couple of rows really late night when my wrist was killing me, but about 95% of this is all me. Honestly, though, this whole chunk of the farm is actually pretty much fully grown, which is crazy to me. There's literally tens of thousands of potatoes here. I need to just finish this thing off now and get it done because I've got other priorities I need to do in this video. And this just needs to get complete. I've done this pattern. I've done that pattern. I'm going to do one more pattern that will hopefully look kind of satisfying. Also, subscribe. Thank you. Can you believe, ladies and gentlemen, about 3 or 4 days of just placing carrots, this farm is finally done. And other than that weird section over there, it's looking very satisfying. Look at that part. At least you can see that. Does anyone actually have a bigger carrot farm than this? I know lockdown has one, but I have no idea if it's bigger or not. But I hear you ask, Zetro, where are you going to keep all these lovely carrots that you're going to be farming? Well, let me explain. So, of course, I like to have big builds in my Minecraft hardcore world. So, why not have just a giant carrot to keep them all in? I mean, it does make sense. Although, there's one problem, and that problem is the fact that I have no materials to build this thing. So, I'm thinking if I can make a sheep farm and then just get orange and green sheep, that should be pretty much all I need just for the carrot. I'm probably just going to build it as like an attachment to this cow farm, just so all of my animals are in the same place. Grab some of this. Plant some of these. And I'm sorry, but I've got to steal some of these. Oh, another. And another. And another. Oh my god, I'm getting spoiled today. Come on, guys. Move along. Move along. Wait, am I even going to be able to fit these guys with just one single fence gate? Okay. They're working. They're going through. Come on, guys. Use your brains. Get in here. Get in. Wait, maybe I need to make the red dye, then the yellow dye, and put it together. There we go. Wait, do I have any more poppies? I don't think I do. It's fine. We'll go on a mission to get some. Oh, is that a poppy? No, it's not. I will take that. Oh, jackpot. Yeah, that is definitely going to be enough orange dye for now. I'm also going to need some green dye, but I think that is only from cactus, I believe. And there's one problem. I don't have a desert, but we'll worry about that in a second. First of all, I'm going to pretty much dye two of these, you and you. Okay, I just took a look online and apparently literally the only way to get green dye is from a cactus. Well, I've got an idea. First of all, I'm just going to check my chest just to be safe. Nope. 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 No. 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 But now I think I'm going to be going on a quest to find a desert. Literally, not even for the temples, not for the villages, for a cactus, which I've got a feeling is going to take a very long time, seeing as I've never seen a desert in this world. Wish me luck. Now, after finding the cactuses, I could officially tell you, I did not realize what I was getting myself into. This was about to be the longest journey anyone has ever went on to get a cactus in Minecraft ever. Trust me. Look at this. We've got white sheep. We've got black sheep. Why can't we just find a green sheep? And a grey sheep. What's going on? I have a feeling that you can maybe get cacti from a pirate ship. So I'm going to see. Or maybe even just green dye. Either one would work. Nope. I mean, the loot is obviously a lot better than a cactus, but I mean, it's not exactly what I need right now. Ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't look like a lot for you, but I've literally been going around for about an hour and a half, but I think I finally maybe found a desert. No, it's literally just the edge of an ocean. And my friends, after multiple hours, this happened. Wait. Wait, 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 wait. Oh my. Finally. This is literally the next day. This took me technically 2 days. There is no way. It's literally taken probably combined around 5 hours to find this. Oh my goodness. And I can get cactuses from over there as well. Two biomes in one. Right, time to go home. Wait a minute. There's also an ocean where I'm pretty sure... What was that? What? Something is wrong with this mic. Did you guys just hear that? What? This mic is broken. I'm going to need to get that fixed. Anyway, though, I should be able to get sea pickles down here, I'm pretty sure. Here they are. And if I'm not mistaken, these can get me lime wool. This is going to be the best carrot in the world. And now I need to travel thousands of blocks to get home again. And 15,000 blocks of walking later, I'm finally home. So now just a couple of things to do. First of all, I need to smelt the cactus. And then also these sea pickles. And dye these sheep. And now I'm going to keep breeding and shearing these guys until I eventually have enough wool for my giant carrot.
2,000 years later.
Goodness me, that took way longer than it should have. Now, the carrot is actually pretty simple. So I start off with a base that is one block tall. And then this is a second layer, which is actually two blocks tall. And then we go for our third layer, which is two blocks tall. And this is going to be the only three block tall layer. There we go. I'm hoping this is actually looking like a carrot, but we'll see in the end. Oh, and the last layer added. Look at that bad boy. I think I'm just going to, first of all, make like a base layer out of green. And then I don't even know. I suppose kind of just like do random bits of wool coming out of it. It looks okay. Okay, wait. I've actually thought of something so much better than this. Here's what I'm thinking. I'm just going to place this, I don't know, right here quickly, just so it can maybe grow a little bit. And then we're actually going to get rid of this green up here. Oh yeah, I also found a trident earlier, just in case you wanted to know. Let me quickly just grab a little bit of dirt. This dirt is going to hold all of the bamboo that I was able to get from that nice little farm over there. Well, it wasn't really much of a farm. It was a bit of a bamboo patch. Oh yeah, I think you can see where I'm going with this. It's going to look like it's literally plucked out the ground, but wait. Wait till it all grows. Look at that. It literally looks like it's straight pulled from the ground. Also, how do you rate my carrot? Out of 10. Just know that if you say 1 out of 10, I'm going to be very sad. Oh, wait. We definitely need some torches in here. Is that going to light this place on fire? I hope not. Now we're going to go chest, 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 and just a couple more chests. And there we go. We now have a carrot that is full of a bunch of carrots. I think this is a success. Look at the size of this farm. I still can't get over this thing. Now, for the final part of the video, getting loads of villager farmers so I can just sell these carrots whenever I want and get infinite XP and emeralds. So, step one, kill sheeps for beds. This is definitely not where the beds are going to be staying, but I'm just going to chuck them down for now so I have somewhere for them to go. So we're probably going to go to maybe around here, and then we can, of course, connect up this wall here. Oh, that looks so much better. Is this going to be enough beds? I might have to put some this side as well. We're going to need to breed loads of villagers to actually have all the farmers to trade with. Oh, I'll be back when I've got all the villagers. So, I've successfully somehow managed to get probably around 50 or so villagers. And if I'm not mistaken, every farmer I'm pretty sure has a carrot trade. All the carrot trades, they're rolling in. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got the giant carrot to hold all the carrots. We've got this massive carrot farm. We've got all the farmers. I deem this as a success. Hopefully you enjoyed the video and I'll see you in a bit. Bye-bye. Okay, I was going to start the video, but quickly before I do, look what happened to me just over there. Okay, this is possibly the rarest thing I've ever seen in Minecraft Hardcore, but how does this skeleton have full netherite armor? I didn't give him the armor or anything. Wait, his helmet broke. Wait, let me see if I get the armor. What? He didn't drop any of it. Wasn't that insane? Now, we started off the XP journey with probably the easiest XP method I could think of at the time, which was trading carrots with all of my farmer villagers. Look at that, from level 52 to level 53. I don't think it's going to cut it. So, I believe episode 4 is time to finally head to the end, kill the Ender Dragon, and make myself an Enderman farm. But before I even thought about this end fight, I had to collect up a bunch of items. I didn't want to go in there pretty much empty-handed, risking my whole world. I started off by getting the most OP bow in Minecraft, and come on, I had to test it out. Okay, yeah, this thing is good. Then off I went to the Nether to get some more supplies for the Ender Dragon fight, specifically ones that I would actually get from a Nether Fortress. Is that what I think is? Okay, I might have to take some of these out. Oh, now we're getting to the good stuff. You can go. Goodbye. I'm hoping 20 blaze rods is going to be enough. Okay, yeah, here we are. And in fact, I believe that is pretty much everything, which means I can go back home. Moving on from this, I eventually made my way back home and used these materials to actually make slow falling potions. potions. This is the whole reason I needed all the materials. And of course, I also got other things prepared as well. I made loads of god apples, killed a lot of endermen for the Eyes of Ender. And I was ready to head to the end. Oh, this way. And we carry on. Oh, it's changed direction. Okay, this is interesting. Anyway, I believe the portal, though, should be straight down this way. Where is this portal? Oh, my goodness, ladies and gentlemen. So now that I was all ready, I popped a slow falling potion and headed straight through the portal. In fact, I definitely need to take out these first. There's another and another. This is why I need infinity. That's all of them taken out. Now, all I have to do is literally just spam the Ender Dragon with arrows. Wait, how is there dragon breath in the air? There's literally nothing there. Wait, it's actually so close. There we go. We did it. We have defeated the Ender Dragon once again. Wait, I should also try and steal the Ender Dragon egg. Thank you very much, Mrs. Dragon. But it wasn't time to leave the end just yet. I had one more thing I quickly wanted to do. Just going to really carefully bridge across. I'm going to drink another slow falling just to be safe. Slow falling is such a lifesaver in these situations. I am beginning to see a city. Oh, did a pirate ship. This one could have a ship. It's a big end city. Come on. Oh, wait. I think it does. The first time flying with this elytra is going to feel amazing. Don't mind me, just going to float over. And ladies and gentlemen, it is safe to say I finally got myself an elytra. And that was it. I'd now be able to fly literally wherever I want so quickly. This was just going to make every project so much easier. You know what would also be useful? Putting unbreaking, but also mending on these elytras just so they don't break. I can finally see my carrot farm. It looks so cool from above. Now it is time to start actually getting XP this episode. I haven't got it yet. I'm heading back to the ends to make a Enderman farm. Into the portal we go. Now time to get ourselves that level 1000, baby. Apparently I need to go 128 slabs out. So bear with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now apparently I need a 15 by 15 platform. And I filled it in as well because this is where I'm going to be going AFK. Right, we're going to go chest, 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 hopper and hopper. So we're going to go 1 and then go up 42. Now I'm just going to build that tower a few more times. Oh yeah, and this time lapse pretty much glitched, so sorry about that. Now, I know this is going to look kind of weird, but apparently I need to get rid of all of these blocks here and just let the water go down. This is where it gets a little bit confusing, okay? Could you just move, please? Could you just... Yep, that, yep. Thank you. So I basically need to make a cobblestone square. Connect that bad boy up. You can go. Gotta place some good old trap doors. Oh, wait. I just remembered what I'm going to need to do now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 3 more times. Oh, you thought I was done there. Gotta join all these bad boys up. Probably fill them in as well. Probably cover them in gold. Probably enchant them with diamonds. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. Basically, I'm saying it's going to take a long time. Now, it was time to try and get an endermite to spawn in this farm to get it to actually work. And it was probably the hardest part to do out of the whole farm. Oh, yes. Okay, thank goodness. Oh, no. And it begins. Are they going to spawn? Oh, here they are. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. We've got it working. And now that the farm was done, I tested this bad boy for an hour to see how it did. Level 134. That means I gained around 70 levels just while doing this. Look at all that. And level 200. There we go. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. And just to show you how high of a level 200 is, look how little XP it gives me when trading with the villagers. How am I going to get to level 1,000? Obviously, my XP bar, as I use this enderman farm more and more, is starting to slow down quite a bit. I'm thinking about making another farm, to be honest. But so I just want to use this one a little longer and see how long it will last for. As you can see, I've managed to gain loads and loads of levels, but look how slow my XP bar goes up. This is not sustainable. And I mean, now, anytime I need to grab XP, even though I'll probably never need to ever again, I can just come here. Enderman farm, you have served me well, but it is time to move on to a bigger and better farm. I need something better. Now, I hopped back into the overworld, but it wouldn't be for long as I was soon going to need to head straight into the nether. Now, here behind me, you can see loads of chests. And you may be asking yourself, Zetro, what is in these chests? My friends, I have right here all the materials needed to to make the Il Mango gold farm, which I built in my old world, and it's insane. But I can't exactly transport all these materials in these chests. That'll be so annoying. So I have made it to, I believe, what is the top of the Nether. I'm pretty sure anyway. I've been digging for ages to actually try and find it. But I believe that block right there is where I need to go through for me to be above the Nether. In fact, I'm pretty sure I need a ladder. Ah, here we are. 3, 2, 1. There we go. I'm out. In fact, I need to quickly mark the block that I got out on. I'm just going to put a shulker down. I'm just going to build myself a nice little end portal just to make sure I can eventually get out if I need to. So this is how we're going to attempt to try and blow a hole through so we can get back under when we need to. So we're going to go obsidian, obsidian, lever, 2 bits of TNT, and then one of these trapdoors. Right there. One piston where the hole needs to be here, and another in my hand ready to place. All right, flip the lever, get under here, spam, 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 spam. That definitely didn't work. Oh, it did! Okay, I probably just hurt someone's ears with the headphones, but I did not think that was going to work. And now I had to build up, but I didn't have any scaffolding. Luckily, I had some netherrack blocks in my inventory that I just piled up, and it got me where I needed to be. We need to put glass here, and I should be on level 236. And this is going to become a 7x7 platform. Block, hopper, 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 glass, ladder, and some more glass to make another little platform. I think these bits here are actually where the piglins fall into. All right, as you can see, I've managed to get the base platform, whatever you want to call it, done for this gold farm, which I'm very excited about. Although there's one thing that I'm not too excited about. Well, I am if it goes well, but if it goes wrong, it's going to be devastating. And the thing I need to do next is all of the magma layers. If you've seen this farm before, you'll know these magma layers are very finicky. But we're going to give it a go. We'll see what happens. Also, I don't have Frostwalker boots, so this is going to be extremely irritating. Anyway, I've got the magma blocks. I need to build out apparently 8 blocks. I don't know why, but apparently I need to. So I need to go 5, 4, 3, 2, 2, 2, and a bunch of ones. 2, 2, 2, 3. 4, and please line up 5. Okay, that looks about right. Now I've just got to do that a few more times. Now I'm going to check the tutorial again, but I'm guessing I'm going to have to fill this in. Surely it's not going to be left just like this. Yep, I need to fill it in.
A few moments later.
There we go. That is now all sorted. Looking good. Although this one was quite easy to do, I'm feeling like the other ones are going to be a lot harder. Here, if I'm correct, I need to go up 3 blocks. Oh, no! Get away, get away, get away, get away, get away. You. Go. Oh my god, imagine if I hit one of these right now. Anyway, alright, I'm getting distracted. And again. I can't be dealing with this, man. Just let me build a farm. See, this is the issue. I'm gonna get the outlines of these rings done so I can just get placed in the glass and then the gas won't actually spawn. What? Why are these guys all after me now? I'm so- well, I didn't even do anything. Maybe I'm just gonna have to leave the Nether and come back, I suppose. Look at these guys falling. I mean, I suppose I'll take the XP. It'll contribute to the 1,000. All right, I'm back in the moment of truth. Are they still angry at me? Oh, there we go. I'm off the hook. Now I need to get this done. Now with the gas out the way and the piglins no longer annoyed at me, I finished this magma ring, but the replay mod messed up a little bit. Okay, did I finish doing this ring? Yes. Did I completely forget to make it as a time lapse? Also, yes. But is this farm going really well and we're going to be at level 1,000 in no time? Also, yes, ladies and gentlemen, this farm is getting there. It's not done yet, but we are getting there. And now for the third circle. Like I said, I'm going to fill this in later on because I want to get to the top layer as quick as possible so the gas do stop spawning. And trust me, they've been so annoying. You'd see if I actually did the time lapse. Oh, I've just seen the list of numbers and this is going to be really difficult. Okay, I've got this. And there is another ring done. But yeah, I think there's one more ring I need to do. I need to fill them all in. So I'm going to quickly get that done because I want to finally get to gathering all of my XP, ladies and gentlemen. This farm is hopefully going to take me to level 1,000, which I'm very excited about. But then it doesn't stop there because I have something special to do with all of these levels. It did take a long time, I'm gonna be completely honest. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this is used to make sure that ghasts don't spawn. But now, it is pretty much the final part. I think other than doing the storage system, I need to go diagonally this way. Go two blocks out. I think I'm just gonna use minecarts to get a zombie piglin in there. So if one of you can just get into this minecart, that'd be very... Oh, yeah, there we go. There we go. Please don't hit him. All right, nice. Now I can name you. I've got name tags. What do you think? I've called him at Zetro Lobs. I don't know what that is. It's my Twitter. Go follow me. I don't know what happened to my voice just then. Can you take that? Yes, there we go. Please don't jump off. Here is another little guy added to the list. There you go, man. And there's the final one I needed. There we go. Now, all I have to do is add some chests and hoppers that will make the storage system. And that is the storage system complete. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to do it. I need to shoot a piglin and then they should all come charging at me. All right. Oh, God. Oh, no. Okay, I got fireworks just in case. It is working, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I'm going to go AFK for an hour. Bye-bye. 1 hour later, I finally finished going AFK, and I've got to level 315, which is around 40 levels, which I'd say is good, but I kind of want to see how much gold... Oh, my goodness me. Are you telling me every chest is literally full to the brim already? That's insane. Anyone need a gold sword, by the way? I've spoken to someone else that did this video through. You've probably seen his video getting to level 1,000, and apparently I'm gonna have to be going AFK for multiple days. Gotta get that 4 digits, baby. So now I just went AFK for an extremely long time, but it definitely worked out in my favor. And there it is. I am level 900, ladies and gentlemen. I think I've been AFK for around a day and a half. Also, do you see that lava down there? I'll show you after I hit level 1,000, but the lag was getting so bad that I had to make item shooters. Look, you can see it down there. It just shoots out the items that it gets so it doesn't lag. But it has been a journey, and the journey does not stop there. Look at these guys charging me. We are down to the last 100 levels. I'll see you when we get there. Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come. After building multiple farms and days of going AFK, I'm so close. Come on, it's literally one XP bar, and we are level 1,000. I'll literally never need to get XP again. And... there it is. Oh my goodness. Level 1000. This is actually, you can probably hear it in my voice how excited I am. This is crazy. I can finally get out of here. I am so hyped. Look at this. These are the little systems that were collecting up all the items so I stopped lagging. I've got to get spending the levels. I've got to get back. Oh, I can finally turn my sound back up. There we go. Now, actually, in between AFK sessions, I managed to get something done ready for this moment. You may be able to see a lot more librarians than usual in this area. And that is because I've managed to actually get all the enchantments I need left to get God Armor. So you go on there. You go on there, you go on there, and we don't even have to worry about the levels. You go on there, and if I put this chest plate on, I can officially say I have God Armor in Minecraft Hardcore. But there's one more thing. I'm gonna be enchanting all of these at level 30, so I'm gonna start with the shovels and also the swords, and now on to the pickaxes, and last but not least, the axes. Now time for the good part. Boom. And boom, God's tools in Minecraft Hardcore. So in episode 2, I asked you guys to name my sword and my pickaxe, and I completely forgot to make the names. So I'm going to be calling the sword Silent Slayer. I just thought it was a really cool name. So there's the Silent Slayer. Of course, you can see the screenshot on screen right now. So Pog Gamer is gaming. Thank you for the name. And Ayush Prasad. I probably said that name wrong, so I very much apologize. But the pickaxe is literally just going to be called Jimbo. Nice simple name. I liked it. So thank you guys for the names. Anyway, this Minecraft Hardcore world is about to get super interesting with these new farms, these new God Armor and tools. I'm very excited. I'll see you guys in a bit. Bye-bye. Oh, this loot is going to be so useful in the next episode. But before I go looting, we have some other things to do. Just to prepare myself. For example, getting a raid done. I just need to actually find the pillagers. Because you may notice I've still got a shield, which is, it's not very safe. Before going into the end again, we need to get a totem. Okay, I see a pillager outpost. But are there any of, you know, the pillagers with, like, the banner? Not these normal guys. We don't want you. Anything in the chest? No. I keep mistaking these cows for pillagers. Right, there's got to be one of the good ones around here somewhere. And that's the one I need to try and find and kill. I guess I can just kill you guys in the meantime. E3, my good sir. There you go. You're welcome.
Watch out, watch out.
What a battle. Oh, here we are. Luckily, my good friend, you're an extremely easy mob to kill. In fact, you know what? You're going to die to my fist. There we go. And that's actually my first banner in this world. Now, if we just head back to the village and the madness begins, ladies and gentlemen. Right, let's get this going. Where are the mobs at? Oh, look at these guys. They're frantically running around. Don't worry. I've got you. Don't you dare hurt my iron golem. Come here. Go, go. Easy. First round done. Eat some carrots from my lovely farm. Look at the size of this thing. Anyway, don't get distracted, Zetro. Come on. Come on, this is easy. Give me a challenge. Where are the Ravengers at? Oh, I think I found them. Come on, Mr. Ravenger. Try and get close to me. Try and get close. I dare you. Oh, no. No, don't you dare. Get out of here. Honestly, I thought this was going to be a lot harder. Oh, and I've got slowness. Great. I've got to drink some milk.
He needs some milk.
Rickshot. Easy. Right, let's get the rest of this raid done. The villagers are setting off fireworks. No way. I did not know they did that. Look at these guys. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have a fair few totems now, and that is the first raid done. I'm so happy that I've finally got a totem. Now, at least if anything bad happens, ladies and gentlemen, we have a backup. Anyway, now, you see this snazzy shulk right here? Yeah, there's nothing in it. But we're going to be filling that shulk up with a bunch of stuff just to get me ready for going into the end for all this time. Starting with using Jimbo to get us loads of carrots. So these can just sit over here. Now, I'm also going to make some slow falling potions just to be safe in case my elytra breaks midair. At least I've got these to land the fall. Oh, that's regeneration. Please, I just need some of your membrane. That is all. That's all I want. And just like that, they're all gone. Just pop this in here. Here we go. This is what I needed. Now, let's also make it last a bit longer as well. And there we go. Perfect. Now, I'm also going to quickly head to the nether so I can grab some gold from a giant gold farm. I suppose if you didn't see this, just check out the last video. There we go. We've now got the food prepared for our mission in the end. Oh, fireworks as well. Luckily, I've got a bunch in this chest already. We're definitely going to need a bunch of fireworks. And you know what? Just to finish it off, let's chuck in the regeneration from earlier. There we go. That is for all the loot I'm going to be collecting. I am fully prepared now for my first hour of this journey. Ladies and gentlemen, let the first hour of this 10 hours start now. Okay, so I'm pretty sure this first end city right at spawn is probably going to be looted, but I'm going to go for it anyway. I'm actually so excited for this challenge. It's just kicked into my mind how sick this is going to be. The amount of loot I'm going to have by the end of this. And if you're wanting to click off the video right now, at least just see how much loot I get after the first hour. I guarantee it's going to be insane. Oh, we got an elytra. I'll take that. And I'll take this stuff too. Oh yeah, I'll also take these. You know what? I'm going to grab the dragon head as well. I might not do it every time, but we'll grab a few. You can see sitting there. Look at this shulk already, by the way. I've got a feeling we're going to be doing a lot of trips. Yes, I managed to grab the loot. I'm out of here. Goodness me, shulkers are so annoying. That is a shulker full already. On to the next one. Yeah, I'm definitely going to be doing a lot of trips back to the overworld. Okay, I think that's probably all the loot from here. Oh, no, wait. We've got another culprit. Don't mind if I do. Whoa, that is a lot of diamonds. Oh, okay. This is interesting. I'm assuming this is going to be another elytra. I remember looting a bunch of end cities once, and I literally just chucked all of the loot in one of these chests. So if we find that little jackpot, that is going to be very useful. Speaking of useful, thank you very much, Mojang. Is this that special chest? It is not. We will find it eventually. Oh, that's a fair few diamonds. We'll take those. I can't wait for you guys to see what I'm going to do with all this stuff. I've got a project for the next episode. You just wait and see. It is going to be good. That's two shulkers down already. Look at that. I will take it. Okay, I think I'm just going to keep looting for the rest of the hour and see where we're at by the end. Okay, so I've got around 20 minutes left. That means it's only been 40 minutes and I've already got all of this loot. 40 minutes out of 10 hours. Can you imagine how much I'm gonna have by the end? I'm so hyped. It's gonna be nuts. But I think what I'm gonna do now is go and finish this last part of this first hour and then head to the overworld and see where we are at. Never know, maybe I'll be on my way to a diamond beacon by the end of this video. We'll have to see, but I'm definitely gonna do something insane with this loot. Oh my goodness, that is a god chest. Anyway, I'm gonna go finish this first hour quickly. Oh My goodness, my light should break. Okay, that scared me so bad. If that was, like, above the void or something. Oh, my goodness, my heart. That was scary. Anyway, time to head home and see what I got from my first hour. I'm very excited. Now, I would say that was definitely a successful hour of looting. 12 shulkers completely full of loot. So, I'm just going to sort them out into all of these chests here so I can show just how much loot I managed to get in the first hour. Honestly, wow. That's probably the best word I can use to describe all of this loot. Look at that. We've got all the iron tools, all of the iron armor as well. Then we go into the diamond tools. Look at all them. We have a bunch of random stuff here. Look at all the potions and the diamond armor. And then you have the diamond armor, the minerals, all of the elytras. And all of this is just from the first hour out of 10. Honestly, I'm so hyped for the end result. Anyway, I've emptied out the shulkers. I'm all prepared. It is time for hour number 2. Let the timer begin. I want to try and get at least 10 elytras from this looting trip. If I can actually do that, that'll be insane, but we'll see. If I can't do that, I'm going to be disappointed. Oh, I see a ship in the distance and it's looted. Oh, no way. I left all the things in here. All right, well, I'll grab them now. Maybe these are the chests that I was talking about earlier. Wait, that might mean this pirate ship is full too. Come on, please just be full of loot. And yes, 2 elytras in here. Okay, this is what I was talking about earlier. Also, I'm going to make a deal right now. If I don't get to the 10 elytras that I want by this hour, I'm going to have to do a forfeit. Come on, I've got to do this. Oh, it's not an elytra, but we'll still take it. 3 pieces of diamond armor. That's pretty good. The trouble is I've got to travel out so far now to get pirate ships because I've looted all the nearby end cities. Come on, Mojang, be generous. If I just go up here, look at that. I can literally see 3 pirate ships. Now, if all of these aren't looted, this is going to be the biggest jackpot ever. Oh, it's actually not looted. Okay, that means surely the others aren't going to be looted either. There's 1 elytra. We'll take that. Come on, this second pirate ship, please don't be looted. I'd really appreciate it. Yes. Okay, nice. Oh, so many diamonds as well. Couldn't ask for a better pirate ship, could you? Okay, please don't hit me one of these little orb things. I don't want to be floating midair. I'd really appreciate it. I said don't. No, at least it saved me a firework. Give me good loot. Give me good loot. Give me good loot. I'll take it. And time for the last ship. I think we all know the answer. Lovely. And we continue. Come on. Please don't be looted. Oh, wait. Is it looted? Hey, there we go. Please just stop. Just stop. Stop right now. Right. I'll take that. I'll take that. And I'll take that. It's going good, ladies and gentlemen. We're only halfway through the hour and it is going well. I'll take those. Come on. I still need more elytras or else I'm going to fail this challenge and that does not look like it has a pirate ship. Come on. Surprise me. Oh, there is. I am such a lucky boy. Give me that elytra right now. Yes. It's just too easy. Oh, we've got another double whammy. I'll take that. I'm actually kind of hyped, but also kind of nervous to see how many elytras I've got by the end. I've actually just realized I'm down to my last, like, 5 minutes. This might be my last end city of this whole hour. Please, no. Okay, another end city looted. In fact, I think I'm going to head back to the overworld now. And now this right here, ladies and gentlemen, is what 2 hours of end looting looks like. And yes, I did actually manage to get over 10 elytras. I got 14 to be exact in that hour. In fact, you know what? This is 2 hours of loot. I've got some empty chests over here. Let's get 3 hours of loot. All right, there we go. Back to the chests after hour 3. I'm not going to lie. I really could not be bothered to sort all the chests out again. I just chucked them all here. But as you can see, quite a successful hour. Although I think I need to stop showing you guys the loot. It's going to spoil the end of the video. But anyway, 3 hours down, a lot of loot collected. Does anyone else just feel like really cozy when it's raining in Minecraft and you're in your house? Let's just sit and listen to this for a minute together. Ah, nice and cozy. Also, do you remember earlier when I mentioned how it's getting harder and harder to get these items because all of the end cities near my portal are all looted, so I have to travel even further? Well, I have a plan for that. I'm just going to do 1 more hour to get to hour 4, and then I'm going to do something a little interesting, which I'll show you about in a second. Ah, we meet again, old friend. And just like that, we're ready to go looting again. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll see see you on the other side. Now, if I head just down here, you can see all of the loot from the past 4 hours. But I'm going to stop showing you because I want to leave it as a surprise until the end. But just know that 4 hours in, we've got a lot. But now, ladies and gentlemen, I have an interesting idea that we're going to test out. In fact, first I'm going to need to head to the Nether to get just 4 gas tiers. Anyway, now that that's done, time to actually tell you the plan. So, you know how I was complaining how I'd already looted all the end cities that were nearby? It costs just 1 gas tier, 1 eye of ender, and 7 glass to get an end crystal. So, if we can make 4 of those, I can kill the ender dragon again, get a new portal, and hopefully be in a completely new location with new unlooted end cities. So, I've clearly already got enough glass. I've got the 4 gas tiers right here. All I'm going to do now quickly is head over to my end portal, head right into here, and then go right over here just to grab myself some ender pearls. Not quite that many. And back into the overworld to make some eyes of ender. But Zetro, you don't have any blaze rods. I've come prepared, okay? Pop these bad boys in here, grab some of that, put those in there, and there we go. 4 end crystals. Perfect. Now, the next part of the plan, to go back to the end, as we were literally just there, and kill the ender dragon. Again, that goes there, that goes there, that goes there, and that goes there. Oh my goodness, it's happening.
God, okay, it's happening.
Yeah, there it is. All right, I'm gonna take out the end crystals first. Easy, boom. Oh, I missed. How do I keep missing? Oh my goodness. Easy. Oh my goodness. Okay, I did not realize I was that close. I need to stay very, very far away when shooting these. If I didn't get my totem earlier in this video, I would have died just then. I can't believe that. Come on, just one last crystal. All right, there we go. Done. Now, to be completely honest, that scared me so badly. I'm just gonna shoot this guy until he dies. And the last hit. Goodbye, Mrs. Ender Dragon. Oh, no. I need to be more careful. That scared me so bad. Wait, surely there should be a new portal. Oh, there it is. There is what we needed. But before anything, I need to go grab another totem. How have I just grabbed totems in this video and I'm already using them up? Now, at least with that Ender Dragon killed, it's time to test out this little portal method. Right, let's find me one of those end cities. Come on, fingers crossed. Oh, it's all loading in. It does seem like new generation. Okay, is it looted? It is not. Okay, the method actually worked. Oh, this is going to be amazing. I'm going to get so much loot right now. Okay, so a method I think I'm going to do. Okay, this is west. I'm only going to actually fly west, which means I won't get all confused with where I'm at. And this should be a very successful trip. Oh my, that is probably one of the biggest end cities I've seen. Okay, come on, please. Please do not be looted. Is the method still working? Oh, no. It's already been looted, ladies and gentlemen. It is a sad day. You know what? Honestly, it's fine, though. If I just keep flying west, then I'm going to get a bunch of end cities that I've never looted. So, you know what? We're just... Oh, this is definitely going to be looted. Oh, wait. What? There's no shulker here, but there is an elytra. Okay, this hasn't been looted. All right, things are looking good. This is going to be a successful hour. You know what? I've actually just realized I'm spending hours and hours and hours trying to find this loot. I've also almost died for this loot a couple of times, and I'm just chucking it in these random little chests outside my house. It's not a great way to treat the loot, you know what I mean? You know what? I'm gonna get this hour done to get us to the halfway point, and I think it's time to make some proper storage. Okay, my elytra is literally about to break. I've just looted my final end city for the first half of these 10 hours, and the timer is about to end in 3, 2, 1. Halfway through. Okay, since I recorded the last clip literally like over a week ago, I've decided something. You know what? We don't have enough cool builds in this world. I mean, it is literally, what, episode 5? But I want some cool stuff. This carrot just isn't cutting it. So, here's the plan. I'm going to grab this shulker. In fact, we'll grab 2. I'm going to make my way back over to the end portal. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this might seem crazy, but I want to grab every single one of these blocks and build myself this, but in the overworld. Right, now time to grab some screenshots. We'll grab one from this angle. We'll grab one here, 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 and then here. Also here, some up the top, and also some around the outside. Okay, I'm ready. In fact, I'm actually going to start off by grabbing all this glass. Wait, can I even grab end rods? Oh, I can. Wow, they are very easy to break. Now I think I'm going to grab all the blocks layers by layer, starting here, going all the way down to there. So now that I have all of the materials for the build, it's time to actually find out where it's going to go. And I'm thinking this mountain right here would be perfect. I'm just going to need to flatten it out a little bit. Okay, I think this is all right. In fact, let me get rid of these flowers quickly. Okay, now all the animals are gone, I have a great way to tackle this situation. Now, here's the thing. I want it to look natural. So what I'm going to do to make sure I actually get the right shape is keep the outline where it is at the moment. And we're going to dig out all of this inside area. And then we're just going to fill it in with endstone. And there we go. Honestly, this is going to get way too confusing for my brain, I think. So I think we have just an 8x8 square of this per block just in front of this little entrance here. So this should be correct. So there's our base layer. Introducing a new block. We're going to make some pillars, I believe, on these corners, 3 high. We're going to do some walls, although I'm not actually sure where the glass is going to go yet. I'll figure it out. Is this right? This looks so weird in the overworld. And then if we just put these blocks here, by the way, why does this look like an inside of a banana? Anyone agree?
No.
So these can go here. All right. I think it's looking accurate. It's looking good. Hey, buddy, what are you thinking of it? Now I'm just going to go ahead and start adding this second layer. We've still got stuff to do down here. Oh, this is so confusing. Oh, wait, I need to leave some space out here as well. I think I then also need to add some staircases going around here. This part is a little bit confusing, to be honest. I don't know how anyone does this. This is actually really hard to try and do.
Several bad puns later.
Oh my goodness. Okay, this is actually looking good. Look at the little shulkers we've got down here. Okay, yes, they're not actually real. They're just normal shulkers, but still. And as you can see, I finally managed to work out this little stair pattern. It literally took so long. Now here in the middle, we have like a little ladder thing and some stairs leading up to it. I want to get this exactly correct. It might be a bit difficult though. Oh, we actually have 2 more stairs here. In fact, they need to be rounded off. How do I do it? Is it like that? There we go. In fact, I think that's actually correct. I'm quite proud of myself. It seems like there's like a big tube thing here, which doesn't seem too hard to build. Oh yeah, we also have to put stairs here, 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 and here. Now I just gotta repeat that 3 more times. There we go. I think that looks good. And I've done the actual bottom layer for the next part of the build. And it's actually, I think, the same pattern as this, meaning it goes a layer of pillars all around the outside, and then actually another 2 layers of pillars, and then a layer of these blocks like I did with down there. And once again, just doing this pattern a few more times. Oh, this thing is looking spicy. Come on, what do you think in the comments? Is this looking good so far? We're almost done. In fact, you know what? It's time to get this thing finished. Look at this bad boy, perfected to the T. I didn't realize that's the only part I actually had to do left. But look at it. It is literally perfect. I had someone you guys may know, Sandiction, help me out with this, but it is actually looking very, very sick. We've got the chest in the right place. This is looking good. The only thing that isn't exactly accurate about this is the torches everywhere. Other than that, this thing is actually looking amazing. It actually looks like an exact replica of the ones that actually in the end built by the game. I'm very proud of this thing. It's so detailed. We've even got the shulkers right at the front. Oh yeah, and I've actually completely forgotten what we were actually meant to use this for. It's meant to be for storage. So I'm going to make a couple of adjustments quickly right here. We're going to grab a bunch of wood from these trees I put down earlier. I'm so glad I made these god tools. That was so fast. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just check the last video. Anyway, though, now I'm going to make a bunch of chests with that wood. Oh, I already have 44 over here. Okay, anyway. Anyway, though, now this is just where I'm going to keep all of the stuff. It's not going to be like a storage system or anything. Just going to be some temporary storage for our end loot, okay? Now I'm just going to transfer all of the lovely loot. Oh my goodness, look at all that. Oh, ho, ho, the loot is looking good, my friends. The loot is looking good. And this is only half of it. You wait and see. Now, I mean, it's been fun making this little build, but it has been a while since I've done some end looting, so I've got to get back to it. There's some more loot to add to their collection. You'll see more of that later on. It's getting a bit hard to loot these NCs. They're all looted, the ones nearby. I think you know what's got to be done. There we go. There's our new portal. Going into hour number 8. Hopefully this is going to be a lot better. Just gonna stock up on some more fireworks. And don't mind me, I'm just gonna head back into the end for a couple more hours to finish off the 10 hours. I'm sorry, I just really want to see all this loot. I need to get it done as quick as possible. I'll be right back. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you can officially see what 10 hours of looting end cities looks like. Honestly, this is insane. Two double chests completely full of elytras. So over 100 elytras, all of this diamond armor, which is fully enchanted. It's crazy. Of course, the saddles, the diamonds, the golden iron. And I think I know what I want to do with it, but if you want to give me some ideas as well, that would be awesome. Can you imagine just a vault full of all of this on show? Hundreds of armor stands. Oh, it's going to be crazy. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. I cannot wait to do something with all this loot. Anyway, I'll see you in a bit. Bye-bye. I have so many projects I want to do in my Minecraft world, but I have one issue. A lot of these projects include items that come from ores. And I mean, I've already done 10,000 ores in the past, so I think you know what needs to be done. I need to one-up myself and mine 20,000 ores so I never have to mine ever again. So pretty much the plan is to have four different mining methods. That is not how you count. Sorry, four. And then each of these mining methods is going to be 2 hours long, which comes to 8 hours. And then I'm going to be able to see which of these mining methods is going to give me the most ores. And then assuming I'm not at my 20,000 ores I'm getting already, I can use whichever method was best to get the rest of the ores I need. Does that make sense?
No.
So, time to collect these ores. This is meant to be an ore, by the way. I guess it's a coal ore. So, method one is actually going to be exploring all the caves in this world. Well, not all of the caves. Luckily, it should be a lot more efficient than normal because, of course, I've got my lovely elytra. I've got hundreds and hundreds of fireworks. We should be good. I've also got a bunch of shulkers, so I'd have to keep going back and forth. And actually, I've just remembered one more thing I need to do. Bear with me. There, having the extra two pickaxes is going to make this a lot easier. There's no way I'm going to need to come back home now. I'm going to be out here for 2 hours straight. So I guess the only thing to do now is let the 2 hours of mining begin. Oh, look at this. We've got some coal. See, I don't even need to go in the caves. Oh. These creepers. Oh, I'm already nervous going into these caves. It's a good thing I'm not going to be going into any ancient cities or whatever they're called. No wardens today. As you can see here, I will literally take any ore possible. Can you imagine if I was trying to do 20,000 ores with just like diamonds and gold and stuff? Goodness me, that'll take a while. Oh, so many mobs in these caves. They're so annoying. I don't know how I'm going to get any sort of mining done. Oh my god. And there's a creeper there as well. Is this challenge even going to be possible? Oh, I'm so weak. Just let me grab some ores. That's all I want. Oh, no more. Mob spawner. Oh, if I fall down here, I'm dead. There's got to be a mob spawner here somewhere. Oh, and they're literally everywhere. How is my inventory full already? There's no way. There's no way my inventory is full already. Oh, I saw this mob loot. Disgusting. Get out of here.
Get out of here.
Oh, I'll take some iron. I've got a feeling I'm going to be getting so much copper this trip. See, look, I told you. Loads of copper. What is your guys' favorite ore in this video? Now, don't just tell me,
oh, diamond, because it's the best.
You got to give me the actual reason. I'm not going to accept diamond just because it's shiny, okay? Like, for example, iron, because you can make iron golems. I don't know. But you got to give me a reason. And I've already got a full inventory. Time to fill up this shulker. Yes, it is pretty much just copper and coal. But I mean, copper lives matter too. Okay? You people, you better be respecting the copper in the comments. I want to see it. Anyway, back to mining. I really would love to find a large ore vein. That would literally save me. But we're just going to keep on exploring. Oh, a ravine. I'll take that. My favorite new ore. I will take this. And a little bit of that. Do you guys like Frostwalker, by the way? I feel like it's actually so annoying sometimes. But it can come in clutch sometimes. Look at this. I can just stand on the water and I'm all good. I don't know. I feel like it works. Also, I want to try and find some more interesting ores, maybe some diamonds. But honestly, I feel like we're not going to find any of those until we get to proper deep caves. In fact, I think I'm going to go find some literally now. I want to explore. Oh my goodness. Okay, there's no way I'm going in this right now. I'm too scared, but I need to grab these quartz. There's a woodland mansion. Oh my goodness. I actually should just live in one of these. It's like a free house. Oh, what in the world is that? Oh, okay, yeah, there's no way I'm going in there. I'm way too scared to go anywhere near that right now. Oh, this is an interesting cave. Any goodies? Maybe something other than coal would be nice.
12 seconds later.
Okay, we're getting down to the deep state. We could actually start to find diamonds now. That would be amazing. We're already finding lapis, which is actually an ore that I haven't come across yet. Oh, we get some iron. Nice little bit of redstone. Is it true that the... Oh, we're in some water. I'm drowning. Is it true that the deep slate coal is actually rare? I have no idea, but maybe I should keep it. Oh, there we go. Very nice. Oh, take a little dive into the water. Oh my goodness. Look at the size of this place. This is insane. Surely there's going to be diamonds around here somewhere. Oh, you love to see it. You really do. Come on, any more? Another diamond ore. Oh, and another diamond ore. Oh, I'll take some more diamonds. More diamonds. Oh, we are racking these bad boys up. Oh, another. Someone could probably just make a complete compilation of just every time I've made a noise. Whenever I find diamonds, I'm like, oh, what? There's something wrong with me. Wait 1 minute, ladies and gentlemen. I have found... Oh, my goodness. This is going to give me so many ores. We have found a large iron ore vein. Oh, this is going to be amazing. Yeah. I still need to be careful of mobs, but we have done it. I'll take that. I'll take that. And I'll take every single bit here. Trying to pay me my money. Right, it literally feels like this method is cheating with these large iron veins. They're insane. Look at the amount of iron I'm getting. And I'm nowhere near done. Destroying this giant iron ore vein has literally taken me under the half an hour mark. How is this taking this long? Whoa. That thunder be sounding like... Thunder be sound... Oh, I've got an arrow in my head. That thunder bee sounded like me on the toilet. Huh? Okay, somehow this literally took me all the way up until the end. See, you can literally see there's still iron left to be mined. There's going to be so many ores in this shulker. Now, method number two. Literally just going to be strip mining. So I'm going to find a random location over here somewhere where I've not mined underground already. I don't want to connect into my one over there. And I'm going to start myself a nice little strip mine. This should be okay over here. Just going to quickly go down to the right level. All right, the timer has started. I'm at level 58. I'm pretty sure that's the right level, if I remember correctly, for diamonds. But if not, I am completely just wasting a bunch of time. Oh, and I was completely right. This is definitely not a waste of time. Oh, a nice little double vein. It's not a double vein of diamonds, but we'll still take it. I do have a feeling that we're going to get a lot less ores than we did when we were doing method one. But I feel like the ores we are going to get are going to be a lot better. Instead of just copper and stuff, we're going to get diamonds. We're going to get gold, all the goodies. And we're going to get a lot of deep slate. I knew this was going to be an issue. This is going to be so annoying. You know what, lava? You know what? You're ugly. Yeah, I said it. I don't want to hear it, all right? Stop making all that noise. Oh, a bunch of tuff. What is this block even used for? Literally no one knows. Ba, 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 ba. I love diamonds. Give me them now. Okay. Oh, amazing. Oh, wait. There was actually loads. The next diamond vein is going to be like two because of how big that one was. Oh, nice little bit of ready. Oh, and a little bit more ready. What am I going to do with all this ready? Actually, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to make farms with it. This is actually going to be so useful. Wait, I didn't capture that. But didn't I just say that the next diamond ore vein is going to give me like two? It literally gave me two right here. I called it. Oh, and we're back to the tuff. Great. Amazing. I love it. Joking. I do not love you. Okay, it's been around half an hour so far, so a quarter of the way in. I'd say we're not doing too bad. Look at all those diamonds. That would probably be around 10 if that was from caves. Definitely gonna have a lot more diamonds from this compared to method one. Also, I cannot wait for you guys to see method four and method three, I suppose. They're both pretty cool. Oh, you're messing up my game. Okay, I could keep using this pickaxe, but I don't want to risk it. I'm sorry, man. You didn't make it to the 1 hour mark. You were close, though. But we've got to switch it out for this bad boy. Look at them. Shiny and new. I just want to get this mining done because I'm extremely excited for the next method. It's going to be explosive. That is what I will say. And now after 2 hours, these were all the ores we got. I know it's a lot less than obviously we got here, but look at the sheer amount of diamonds I got from this one. I'm blown away. But I think method three might be a little bit better. So you know how I just did strip mining. Now imagine strip mining, but with TNT. So I've actually got enough gunpowder from my farm already. I just need to try and find myself loads and loads of sand so I can grab it all up and make a bunch of TNT. Oh, okay. This is a nice little spot right here. We got the turtles because I know there is literally no desert nearby. So this is probably the best we're going to get for now. But I mean, I'll still take it. Is it going to give me enough? Probably not, but we'll see. Okay, and after all that, I've managed to get a bunch of TNT. I don't know if I'm going to need to get more. I would actually have a lot more, but yeah, some accidents happened. So for this method, once again, going to head all the way down to level minus 58, 57, and 58. There we go. Now I'm going to begin to mine for an extremely long time, which is going to be painful because Deep Slate takes so long to mine. Why can the diamond level not be up where the stone is? Oh, well, look, I'm going to power through. Oh, great. Lava. You know, Mojang, if you could just take it out of the game, that'd be amazing. That would make my life so much easier. But you're not gonna, are you? Finally, it is time to start placing all of this TNT. I was gonna actually do every one block, but I think I'm just gonna place on every single block to get the biggest explosion possible. And you're probably thinking to yourself, Zetro, honestly, what are you doing? You're just gonna blow up all of the ores.
No, 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 no.
This is actually gonna show us all the ores that I'm gonna be able to mine inside the walls, and it's gonna be nuts. All I've gotta do is place up all of this TNT. I've actually only just realized how much TNT I'm actually placing right now. It's not exactly 10,000, but it's a lot. This is gonna be one big explosion. And that's the TNT done. Okay, wait, I'm gonna try and use my bow. Oh, it's going, it's going, it's going. I am running for my life because I do not want to get caught in that explosion. Oh my goodness, that was scary. My heart's racing. I'm already getting ores. I'm hoping for some diamonds. I'm just going to hold the torches as we go and break the ores. Hopefully, I shouldn't miss any, but I've got a feeling I will. And you're probably going to troll me in the comments telling me I've missed some. But oh well. All right, let's get these ores. Oh, here we go. Nice little bit of gold. Bit more redstone, lapis. Come on, please give me some more diamonds. I swear last time I did this, I got a bunch more. Maybe I've done something wrong. I've got a feeling I've made a bit of a mistake, but we'll keep going. We'll see. Okay, you know what? I'll take two diamonds at this point. I just want to get myself some more diamonds. Please be some more. Oh, yes. All right, it's only one, but you know what? I will take that. Yeah, we'll take a couple more diamonds, add them to the little collection we got going. Any more, any more, any more? No. I'm actually now realizing I'm pretty much halfway into being done with this method, which is kind of crazy. Time flies when you're having fun, you know? Oh, and we get some more diamonds. We are definitely having some fun right now. Oh, and as we literally come to the halfway point, I think we've come to the end. Look at that. You know what that means, ladies and gentlemen? I've got to head back. I've got to make more TNT and we have to carry on. Oh, finally. We're in daylight after being stuck down there for so long. Here we go. Also going to grab some carrots from my amazingly big carrot farm and go back over to my mine. Come on, round two. Let's hope for a better outcome. Just got to mine out an area. Okay, now time to place all of the TNT. Now, like I said, I'm doing this a little bit different. It's going to take a while because I have to be careful how I'm doing it. But I am going to do every other block just to see how this one works. Hopefully, it's going to be a bit better than last time, but we'll see. I'm going to have to test it out. And there we go. That's all the TNT placed. I need to grab my bow and run. Oh, just look at it go. And now I can spend the last 17 minutes collecting up all the ores. Okay, not amazing, but also not too terrible.
Why the f*** you lying?
Yeah, for 2 hours, that is kind of bad. But at least we got a bunch of diamonds. Now I'm just going to grab a couple of shulkers from here and go into method number four. But honestly, I'm just going to skip over this method because it's quite a boring one. Essentially, what I'm going to be doing is going into the nether and just mining literally every ore in sight. Every ore that I see is going to be grabbed. And then I'll stick them all in here. So I'm going to go loot the nether for a total of 2 hours and then I'll see you when I'm done. Now, just like that, that is all of the methods done. Now, you could say that method 4-1, but I mean, it is literally just quartz and a bunch of gold. So I don't know. You can tell me which you think won. I would say method 1 was probably the best, but method 2 definitely gave the most diamonds. And yeah, maybe we just won't mention method 3. Now I've actually just added up all of the numbers and it actually comes to a total of only around 7,500 ores. So I'm going to go mining in the nether, in the caves and get myself those extra 12,500 ores. Let the mining begin. Okay, wait, I've actually realized we've got to do one thing first. Here we are. Okay, now we can actually get to mining. Have you ever seen 20,000 ores in one place? Probably not, but now you will. Look at all this. Of course, the nether ores, and then we go straight over to the gold. We've got the iron. There's so much iron. All of the copper, the coal. Look at all that. I mean, I'm never going to have to get coal ever again. Redstone for some future farms, and oh my goodness, look at all those diamonds.
Look at all those tickets.
Honestly, this is insane and probably the most doors I've ever had at once. But you're probably wondering, what is that shulker right there? Zetro, why are you being sneaky? Let us know. Tell us what it is. Well, there you go. You now know. But Zetro, what are those materials going to be used for? You shall see. So here was my thought process. I thought to myself, you know what? I don't want to just place these ores randomly. I need something to put them on because I always do that and it just looks a bit ugly. So I'm going to be building Minecraft's biggest furnace inspired by Fruit in his 10,000 ore video. So if you want to go check that out, make sure to. I think I'm going to start off with like the frame, which if I'm correct, is built out of these blocks. There's the base layer. Then we're going to do, of course, the corners. Okay, now if I've done this correct, this block in my inventory here should go from 18 down to 4. Okay, is it correct? Yes, it is. There we go. In fact, I think the easiest part to do is the top and bottom, and I'll show you why. It's because it's literally just cobblestone. That's all it is. I mean, you're not really going to see it, so I thought there was no point in like proper texturing these sides. So there's the bottom done, and there's the top done. Now, I think I can probably fill in the sides because they are all the same. That'll probably be easiest. I think the best thing to do would be to do the front last. Go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and do this all the way across. There we go. Now, this bit is kind of complicated. So give me a second to just fill all these areas in with stone quickly. They won't stay like that. But now, of course, we can't just leave it looking plain like this. We've got to add at least a little bit of texture. I think that's it. I think that's all I need to do. Now, let me go quickly do that on the other sides. And now I've just got to fill it in with this gray concrete. Okay, I actually think this thing is looking pretty sick. All that's left to do is the front, which is the most important part and is pretty much what seals this thing together and makes it look sick. So let me quickly get this done, and I suppose then we can get placing all the ores. Exciting times. Ladies and gentlemen, what do you think of my furnace? I actually don't think it looks too bad. Of course, this right here is going to be where all of the ores are going to go. I think I'm going to do it like maybe a couple blocks in, or maybe I'll just take up the whole thing. But look at this thing. I am loving it. But let me know what you think. Out of 10, I'd give it a 7.2 because it could be a little bit more textured like here, but overall, it's not bad. Anyway, I believe you know what time it is. Time to grab up all of the shulkers. And you got to remember, I'm going to be using fortune as well, so it's going to be way more than 20,000 items. Oh, I don't think I'm ready. Are you? I don't think so. But let's get going. From down here, this thing literally looks insane. Oh, and by the way, can you tell that I made a little bit of a mistake with these nether ores? So this is all the nether ores I have. And yeah, I kind of placed all the gold and didn't realize I had even more quartz. But anyway, there's a little update for you. Oh my goodness. This is insane. Look at the amount of ores. It literally looks like they're being fed into the furnace and it's like burning them. But oh my goodness. Look at this monstrosity. Got a little bit of deep slate coal there. Look at that. Some diamonds at the top. But oh my. I can't believe it. This actually could lead me to a diamond beacon. We'll see though. Honestly, if this isn't the most amount of ores you've literally ever seen in Minecraft, then I do not know what to say. This is crazy. Now it is time for me to mine all of these ores and you to just sit back, relax, and get excited to see the end result. Remember, I have fortune. This is going to be crazy. Put your predictions of how many double chests this is going to take up. I wonder if I'll be able to get a full diamond beacon after this. I didn't mean to. I mean, I'm saying that like it's a bad thing. Of course, it's a good thing. But I literally might get a diamond beacon today by accident, which would be insane. But we'll see. We'll see. There's all of the diamonds gone. Should I show you how many diamonds I got? I could, but I won't. Also, if there are any builders in the comments, can you let me know what you think of this? But I really love gold with lapis. I don't know if that sounds stupid or if that's just me, but let me know, builders, in the comments. What do you think of that? I think it's a nice little combo, you know? This is honestly taking way too long. I'm pretty sure I've been going for over an hour now, just sat here, mining away, minding my own business, collecting up ores. Wait, I have an idea. We're going to head to the Nether, going to find a nearby Nether fortress. Shouldn't be too difficult. Just like this bad boy right here. There's one skull, and that is the second skull. And if I'm not mistaken, oh yeah, I thought I had some at home. Now I can put these with these and kill this guy. Just like so. Look how easy that was. And I combine this nether star with these to get myself a lovely beacon like that. I'm actually going to use a bunch of iron from the last video to make a bunch of blocks. I think around 3.5 stacks is enough. And now this beacon is pretty much going to allow me to break all of these ores so much faster, I'm guessing. And I have myself a beacon. Fantastic. Okay, I think this is actually a little faster. Oh, I'm so glad we did this. You are a lifesaver, my friend. And yeah, you're probably wondering why this is just a screenshot right now. Me being stupid, I completely stopped the replay. And you're basically missing around half of the time lapse because I'm dumb. I'm so sorry. Every single ore out of those 20,000 ores all mined and chucked into these chests. Oh my goodness, this is insane. Can you believe that? Look at all those diamonds, the gold, the lapis. That is a lot of lapis. All the redstone, the iron. Oh my goodness. Look at all of this. This is nuts. I'm literally never going to have to get coal again. Of course, we've got all the copper. We've got all the gold. We've got the quartz. This is nuts, and I'm so glad I did this. And now this video and the last video all led up to one project I want to do. Hopefully it'll be the next video, but all of those items over there, all of those items here, they're all going to be used for this one project. So hopefully you're excited for that. Anyway, that is 20,000 ores mined, and I guess like probably 50,000 plus items here. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in a bit. After these past two videos, I'm literally too rich in Minecraft hardcore. Like, what am I meant to do with all of this? Wait a minute. I have an idea. I'm gonna make a secret base to store all of this loot. That would be sick. So I suppose first I want to head to the Nether so I can kill a bunch of wither skeletons and get loads of skulls. Not only for beacons, but also I think the skeleton heads will look pretty cool on display. Just gotta find a Nether fortress. Oh, here we are. Come on, give me some skellies. Oh, wrong kind. Oh, here we are. I'm gonna have to take out all of these because these blazes are gonna get so annoying. Goodbye. Get you guys gone. And now I can fight these. I think this is the worst Nether fortress I've ever seen for skeleton spawn rates. This is terrible. I'm gonna go find a new one. Oh, this one might work a little bit better. There's a nice 9 wither skulls. In fact, I'm gonna keep 6. Now I'm gonna use 3 to make a wither and kill the wither. And now I can make a beacon. So at least that's that job done. Now, next thing to work on is I need to make this base, of course, secret. Or else it wouldn't be a secret base.
Yeah, no.
So first of all, I actually need to grab some wood. Jeez, this axe is speedy.
Fastest boy.
Now I need a swamp so I can get some slimes and get slime balls for the sticky pistons. I've got a feeling this is going to take a while. Jackpot. Now, where are the slimes at? Hello there, buddy. Please give me enough slime balls. Okay, I think I actually will. I'm pretty sure I need like 4. There we go. That's a little bit more than 4. Now I just need to make some pistons and make them sticky. I actually also now need to make some item frames. Come here, cows. To be honest, I probably already had the leather, but they're fun to kill, aren't they?
But are you serious right now, bro?
There we are. All I need now is a bit of redstone. I need to grab a comparator, and that should literally be everything. Now, I think the door is probably going to go right here, because if I'm not mistaken, yeah, this goes straight into a mountain. But remember, this door is secret. Don't tell anyone. So the first piston is actually meant to go here, and then one here. That doesn't look so secret. There we go. We'll hide it. So then we need 2 more right here, and then I think it's going to be 2 there, maybe. That should be correct. Couple of oak planks here. Okay, well, I don't think I've really given myself enough room for this. I'm gonna dig out a little bit and then we're gonna carry on. Is this enough room? I hope so. And I needed that room because I basically need to build across here, which I believe is where the redstone is going to go. Well, most of it. But quickly before the redstone, apparently I need to put the item frames down. In fact, I think it actually needs to go here. It's fine. We can tweak it after. So now we are gonna go comparator, redstone, 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 repeater. Oh, I've done that the wrong way around. Repeater, comparator. Couple of bits of redstone. Now, if I spin this item, there we go. And then if I take it out, that was not meant to happen. Okay, I've ended up getting a working door, although it is a completely different one because that one just wasn't working, although I think I may need to clean this up a little bit. From the inside, I think this actually looks good. We've got the nice little lever here, and then boom, straight down. And I mean, listen, I never said I was good at terraforming. I suppose it'll look a lot more natural when it's actually all turned into grass. But anyway, at least that's my nice little secret door complete. Now, we need a staircase pretty much going down, but how far down do I actually go? I'm not even too sure. Oh. Okay. This is going to be a bit of an obstacle, but it's fine. We'll get past it. Oh, no. It's okay. It's all under control. It's not. Oh, wait. Luckily, I have a bow. There's him gone. Okay, this should be okay. We'll get there. Go away. Burn alive. There we go. Let me just go a couple more down. There we go. I think that's enough. But I mean, realistically, what kind of staircase is this? I want to make it look good. I just don't exactly know how. I mean, we can definitely start off by making sure I don't bang my head every time I go down the stairs. And I guess these all need to go so they can be replaced with a block. I've just remembered I actually have loads of wood over here from just doing a bunch of tree farming, which is useful. But what do I go with? Stairs or normal blocks? I think we're going to try out some stairs. Okay, well, it's not meant to look like that. I really hope I can make this look good. I do need to come up with some sort of, like, design, though, for these stairs. We don't want some boring, normal-looking things.
Boring!
Honestly, I think this is actually looking decent. You probably couldn't see in the time lapse, but I've got these nice little details down the side. It could be a bit less plain, I suppose, but I think it looks okay for now. What do you reckon? I think it's a nice shape as well. In fact, speaking of shape, that actually reminds me, I need to grab these beacons, grab some iron blocks as well. In fact, one beacon will do, but first I need to dig out an area. I'm going to go ahead and place this beacon here. Hopefully this is the right shape. This could be completely wrong, but we'll see. If it works, then it works. I do want to get the biggest beacon level possible. Wait, I just realized I'm gonna have to dig all the way up, aren't I, because of this thing, this little bad boy, this thing right here. This little... All right. Anyway, let us make our way up. Oh, I think we're about to have light. We have made it to the heavens. Well, actually, it's nighttime, so there's not much light. But I mean, we made it out. Look at that cool little furnace there. Well, it's not exactly little, is it? Anyway, time to make my way back down again. There we go. Gonna give you a little bit of power. And now I have haste too. Meaning I can start making the shape of this underground base. So straight away, I want to make sure it is 3 tall rather than 2. Oh, and actually, I just remembered. I had a really, really cool idea for, like, going into the base. So I'm just gonna block this off for now. We're just gonna make the shape. Oh, I really need torches. That is so much better. Oh, gravel. My best mate. Joking. I hate you. Now, this corridor is getting a little bit long, but I honestly don't want to be above the cave. I don't want the whole base to be right above a cave. So we're going to keep going a little bit more. Oh, bear with me a second. Okay, now that that's all lit up, whereabouts should we end this corridor then? I don't want to make it too long. I'd say we'll go to about here. So I'm actually going to dig out a cool middle area. This is exactly where the beacon's going to go. This is going to be a bit of a project. But the question is, how big do I make this thing? Maybe I should build the beacon first, and then I can see how it looks. Meow. I'm such a pro. In fact, let's head over to our lovely little... Could you call this an end city? I don't even know. Anyway, though, I'm going to grab all of these. All of these. All of these. All of that. And the rest of it. Ooh, look at all of these. We have a bit of an issue. I can't really build a beacon out of that. You know what? We can't quite cook them in there, but I have a plan. Time to make some of these. And some more. And some more. And some more. And some more. Now, let's get to work. No, don't do it. You've got so much to live for. Don't cook yourself. And that is how you get a beacon looking like this. Look at the size of this thing. This is crazy. But you know what? This isn't big enough.
I want more!
So how am I going to make this bigger, you ask? Well, let me show you. I'm going to head to the nether straight up here. Oh, that sound is going straight down. Anyway, though, time for gold.
6.5 hours later.
Here we go. Look at the size of this thing. This is actually nuts. So we have 3 beacons now. I actually had to use the skulls I got from earlier. And then then, of course, we've got my fourth one, but as you can see from my haste, I'm using it for now, but we'll add it on after. Also, I still need to remember to light all this up because, you know, we don't want the mob noises. Every time I go down, I'll go down to get some diamonds and I just hear a good old... Oh, and the mobs begin. Why can't they just make Minecraft hardcore peaceful? No one likes mobs. Oh, there it is. Trick shot. Oh, ho, ho. Do a little bit of mining, get these blocks out of the way, and then do a little bit of dirting. I'm going to grab some torches real quick, BRB. Now let's get this place lit up. I think we'll do down here as well. It's a dark little area. Oh, it's a big area. Get out of here. Now back to the epic Zetro drawing board. There you go. So here is the plan. So of course we have the beacon in the middle already. Yes, that's the beacon. And then this is the hallway leading up to the beacon. So what I want to do is have three other hallways going off the middle area. And then we can have these rooms here. And these three rooms will have different functions. So here we'll have maybe like a chest room. Then we can have like smelting and then brewing and crafting. Stuff like that. So if I forgot to mention it already, the whole thing is actually going to be built out of quartz, which means of course I need to go and grab quartz. Luckily we mined 20,000 ores and there were a lot of quartz, so all I need to do now is turn them into blocks, although this might take a while. And now I'm going to dig out this center area so we can place the quartz, then the tunnels, I hope. Could one of you have just like done this for me, please? My brain honestly can't handle this, but we'll get it done eventually. And that is the lovely shape of the base done. Please tell me you like it. But like I said, for the actual blocks, we've got a bunch of quartz. I think we're just going to mainly make it all just quartz and maybe go around pillars around the sides of the walls just to make it look more official. Some lighting in the ground. It's going to look good. So I suppose I should probably get to work on this. I'm not sure what I'm going to do here, though. Do I do like a quartz tunnel going up to put the beacons in? I think so, but we'll have to see. I might not even have enough quartz, to be honest. But we'll see what happens. This is how we're looking so far. I am loving this little upside down. Well, actually, it's not upside down pyramid. It's a normal pyramid. I'm loving this pyramid, though. How many times did I just say pyramid? Pyramid, 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 pyramid. Anyway, though, I think it's looking good. Of course, we need to do this tube of quartz going upwards. We can't leave it like this, honestly. And then I need to do the roof, and then that is the quartz done. But I just wanted to give you a little update. I think I'm going to have, like, gold on the floor, and then we're going to have lighting in the floor rather than just this monstrosity. It's going to look sick. So I'll get this roof done quickly, and then we can get adding the details. Oh, hello there. You got anything good? That literally looks like poo. Why would you try and give me poo? Disgusting. Anyway, back to work. Oh no, you're joking. This is a slime chunk? Oh no, that could be an issue. And now, time to get this thing decorated. Anyway though, my first thought is to have like gold going here, connecting up to the beacon. Is this gonna look good? Who knows? Hopefully though. I'm thinking of actually taking out this iron. I can keep the iron like on the inside. Obviously it's a full beacon, but this outside part right here, I might just make gold. Doesn't really make sense, does it? So let's get this all gone. Now we go to Gold Town. Look at this. Oh, that looks a lot better. I'm so glad I did this. Now we've got to just add some here. Wow, this is going to cost me a lot of gold.
A few inches later.
I've run out of gold, ladies and gentlemen. I'm poor now. Bruh. It's fine. We can fix this. All I've got to do is leave my house, go to the Nether. Oh my. There's no way I just used a totem. I'm so stupid. Why did I do that? Oh, my heart is racing. Quickly grab. I don't have a totem with me. Okay, I need to go back home quickly. Oh, my heart. My heart is racing. I just saw the hearts going down constantly. I was like, oh no. Right, where is the nearest totem? Oh, okay. There we go. I need to put one in my shulker as well. How is my heart still racing? Back to the gold farm we go. You best believe I'm just walking up these stairs normally. Okay, we're up. Now time to go to Gold Town. Here we go. Now I have the blocks to actually make these little paths. So here's the first one. Now I think I'm going to dig out these tunnels as well. I'm now realizing, looking at all of this bird poo, that we have so much to do. Luckily, these tunnels only need to be about this long, so I don't want anything crazy, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blocks. Ah, we'll make it 8, a nice even number. Here's the other one. Oh, hello, cave. There we go. There's the last one done. We can add the cool details after. I've got some really good plans that you're going to want to see. Let me give you a clue. Armor stands. Oh, I have a good idea. Let's follow the gold all the way into the rooms. This is such an expensive base. Look at this. What am I doing? I think we need to make this a bit more decorative, though. That actually reminds me, I did want to do some, like, pillars around here. I don't know whether to make them 2x2 or 3x3. We'll start with 2x2 first. Does that look good? I think so. There we go. I think those actually look pretty decent. I think we're going to add some more, though, 100%. I then went around and added a bunch of pillars around this beacon sort of area, which made it look really cool, rather than just keeping all the walls quite plain. There's those pillars added. Now we need to do the glowstone. So I've actually got all of this glowstone out of my inventory, but we need to make it go from in my inventory to here. Look at that.
Magic.
I've put a bunch of glowstone on the floor. We've still got torches around the pillars. I do need to put some more lighting up here, but I think this is actually looking decent. But I still think it's missing something, so give me a second. Let me quickly finish this main area, and then this room will be finished. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you our new and improved, well, it's not really that improved, but our new middle room of our underground base. What do you think? For now, I've kept it quite simple. I want that rich Greek kind of building look. Look at this armor. There's so much. It looks so cool. We've got the glowstone around the top for the lighting, but let me know what you think. And then I actually did these rooms here, just nothing crazy, just so we can get straight to work. But yeah, these are the rooms so far. They need to be filled in. So we're going to start off on the complete opposite side to where the entrance is, and we're going to make a brewing room. So first of all, in the middle here, we'll have a little shelf. Oh wait, that's a bit too high. There we go, that's better. So I suppose this can be like the main brewing stand part. I don't know how many brewing stands to have though, because two might actually not be enough. Also, I had an idea for the lanterns, about putting them in each corner just to light up this area. We can have another shelf on this side, literally symmetrical, and then another on this side. And you know what? We'll have some lanterns here as well. I think that'll fit nicely. I think I have some item frames in here. And you know what? A couple more lanterns, why not? Although I feel like we can make the floor a little bit more detailed. I wonder if some stairs would look good. Let's try it. Yeah, I think this looks decent. In fact, instead of the lanterns, I think water would actually be a good fit. Look at that. There we go. Wait, actually, I can add the lanterns as well. Oh yeah, I was also going to put lanterns in the floor. Kind of matches the aesthetic. We'll do some in these corners. Looking good. Now, I think we should put some chests on the side here. That'd probably be useful. Now, would it be dumb for me to put armor stands here, 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 and here? Nah, why not? Let's do it. I just have way too much diamond armor. It's not my fault. Although I will agree, it is a little bit overkill. Look at that. Literally the most pointless thing ever. But I guess it makes nice decoration. You know, it looks okay. I never said I was a great builder slash interior designer. Okay. Oh, should I put my wither skeleton skull here? That would actually make sense. Although, oh no, it's not symmetrical. You know what I've got to go and do now. And there we go. How did I literally get a wither skull within 2 skeletons? Is anyone beat that record? Tell me in the comments. I think this is my broom room done. Tell me what you think. I kind of like it. I also think we could have went for more of a nether theme, but it is not too bad. And with that broom room done, it's actually made me have a great idea. I thought, what can I dedicate another room to? I thought about these things and then like an anvil and stuff like that. And then I realized my enchanting table is sat on the side of a hill. So why not make an enchanting room? There you go, little celebration. Luckily, I have a silk touch pickaxe to grab all of these. This may take a while. And can't forget the enchanting table. Oh no, you are joking. I literally can't put it in the middle. Look, oh, why did I do this to myself? No. You know what? I might even need more bookshelves. We'll see. Boom, 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 boom. You guys are gonna hate me for this. I'm so Look at it. I'm so sorry I've done this to your eyes. Please be nice in the comments. Goodness me, does this look terrible. Just a couple hidden back here, you know? It's fine. Nothing too crazy. Also, if you're wondering how I'm getting all this diamond armor, I'm not cheating. I just did lots and lots of end city looting. Look at that. Amazing. In fact, I think we should make this room look rich. I have an idea. It may look ugly, but it'll look rich, so it's fine. Diamond pillars in every corner. It's like the waterfalls in the other room, but icy. Am I just ruining this place? I hope not. I think I'm going to add stairs around the top as well, like I did literally in there. I think this might look all right. I like how it goes around the diamonds as well. There we go. Not too bad. Oh, I have a good idea for here. So let's take out a middle section. There we go. And add these patterned blocks. Chiseled quartz block. There we go. Fantastic. And then we can add stairs around that as well. Not bad. Now I'm just going to quickly do it on every other side. Oh, here we go. Look, I've even put them here as well, but it's looking so awesome. But this is not cutting it. It looks so bad. Now, I think the last thing to do here is get a little moat going, a little moat around the enchanting table to protect it. Although I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to fill it. It might take a while. There we go. I'm loving this. Keeping it nice and simple. In fact, what if we do this? Yeah, that looks better. Goodbye. Get out and shut your mouth. This looks good, other than that thing. But anyway, second room done. And now for this last room, I don't really have much of a use for it. There is one thing I could do, I suppose. And here it is. I can officially say I finished my underground base. Well, it's actually more of a vault. It wasn't actually meant to be a base, but that kind of just works better in the title. Look how cool these patterns are. Anyway, I'm getting distracted. But yeah, more of an underground vault for all my riches. Yes, of course, we had to add the good old Zetro enchanted diamond armor. In fact, let's make that the word to comment for this video. Diamond armor. Why not? Shows you made it all the way to the end. But look at all these elytras, by the way. Are you ready? Boom. Even more. We've got swords. We've got pickaxes, and guess what? This isn't even all of my loot. I've still got so much more I need to add, but I think I'm gonna end it off here. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you love this base. I actually love this room right here, although I can't really walk in here. I'm so sorry you had to see this again. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in a bit. Bye-bye.